Once it belonged to nature, a forest perched on cliffs overlooking an often stormy bay. Now it belongs to man, and this weekend, to the finest practitioners of the game of golf, they've come to Pebble Beach in California for the United States Open Golf Championship. Often when mankind comes to a virgin land, the beauty departs. Not so at Pebble Beach. The navigator Juan Rodriguez Cabrillo, who discovered it, might wonder at the sight of men hitting a small ball along the breathtaking cliffs, but the beauty remains, and so does the drama. Yesterday, Bill Rogers of Texarkana, Texas, moved into a position from which he might well win the 82nd U.S. Open Golf Championship. After opening rounds of 70 and 73, Rogers, moving steadily along, had this trouble shot on the par 4 15th hole. His intelligence prevailed over daring, and he hit it to the middle of the green. A gambling shot might have put him closer to the pin, but it also might have meant disaster. Then this putt. Bill Rogers, the current British Open champion, tied for second in last year's U.S. Open. But a few more putts like this, and he may hold both titles simultaneously. Like Rogers, Tom Watson of Kansas City has never won the U.S. Open, although he's taken three British titles. Here he was yesterday with his long second shot on the eighth hole, one of the most spectacular sights in golf, across that yawning chasm with waves and rocks below. Pebble Beach is one marvelous view, one nerve-tingling challenge after another, and Watson has been up to it this week. The Open has escaped Tom Watson for too long now, and many feel that when he finally wins it once, the floodgates may open for a cascade of major championships, second only to those of the great Nicholas himself. Rogers and Watson were tied for the lead then at the end of three rounds of play. It should be sport at its best today. Watson, the Huck Finn hero of the Midlands. Rogers, the stalwart pride of the Southwest. Two fine sportsmen at stake, the national championship of American golf. ABC Sports presents a national championship conducted by the United States Golf Association. It began in 1895, and these are the figures of some of the greats who have won the title. From out of the past and present. Today, from the Pebble Beach Golf Links in Pebble Beach, California, it's the final round of the 82nd United States Open Golf Championship. This ABC Sports exclusive is brought to you by Xerox, advancing office productivity worldwide. By the totally new 1982 Continental. It's the trimmest Continental ever fashioned, yet one of the finest riding Continentals ever built. By Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Brewers of Michelob. Put a little weekend in your week. And by U.S. F&G Insurance, protecting your business, your home, your auto, and your life through 6,500 independent agents across the USA. Here has been the progression in the 82nd U.S. Open. Thursday, the first round, Bill Rogers and Bruce Devlin tied for the lead just ahead of King and Heath, Edwards, Clampett, and Deal. Day two, at the end of 36 holes, it was still Devlin, but Larry Rinker had moved into second place, Rogers had dropped down a bit, and appearing on the leaderboard were Jack Nicklaus and Tom Watson. The third round was yesterday, and at the end of 54 holes, it was Watson and Rogers tied for the lead. David Graham trying for a repeat performance as champion here, moving into that tie for third place. Nicklaus still there, and Cal Peet and Craig Stadler. Right now, well, here are the standings as of this moment. It's Tom Watson and Bill Rogers still tied for the lead. Of course, they have yet to tee off. We're going to see them all the way around all 18 holes. David Graham's still there. Scott Simpson has played one hole, as you see, and so has Bruce Devlin. And they have parred them. Lenny Watkins now has gotten one under after three holes. Cal Peet one under. Nicklaus lost a shot. He bogeyed the first hole. Stadler, Clampett, Hole, and Hinkle. That then is the way they stand. The weather conditions very much like yesterday, a little bit warmer, 68 degrees, humidity still high, the wind negligible or none. Today's pairings, the last one of course, will be Watson and Rogers just ahead of them. David Graham and George Burns playing together in the last round for the second year in a row. Remember last year at Marion, Simpson and Devlin up ahead, Nicklaus and Peet on the second hole now, Watkins and Pole up on the fourth. A look at the beach along the bay here. In this spectacular setting, here's the way the hole's set up. In blue, you see the front nine, and in white, you see the back nine with the finishing hole along the lower left there, along the seawall. So that is Pebble Beach. That is the situation. You know the weather. This is the host hotel, if you will, the lodge at Pebble Beach. As we said yesterday, one of the most famous hostelries in the world. And there is the first tee, and on it, the men who are going to try to fight it out for this championship, although there are many others, as we said, with a chance to win, Bill Rogers on the right in the yellow sweater. Here he is, current British Open champion. And after winning the British Open, he really got the bit in his teeth last year, went on to win a lot of other things, and was named the Golfer of the Year. But this year so far, no luck at all. He hasn't been doing a thing until this weekend. A little bit earlier, we talked to Bill Rogers, asked him how he thought he'd feel on the first tee today.
Well, I'm looking forward to it, needless to say, and it'll be fun. It'll be a fun day, and you know, this is what you work for, this is what you strive for, to get yourself in position to win one of the world's biggest tournaments. So hopefully I'm ready, and I'll go after him tomorrow.
Okay, and here is Watson. Never has won the Open. Jack Whitaker talked to him earlier.
What's the U.S. Open mean to Tom Watson?
Well, it's our national championship. It's one of the majors that I haven't won. The other's the PGA, and it's a tournament that I want to win very, very much.
And here would be a good place to do it, wouldn't it?
It wouldn't be bad right here.
What do you want to think about now? Just keeping your game together?
Well, I need to get some very positive thoughts to go out to play with tomorrow. And right now, I'm playing a little bit too defensively. And you can't win this golf tournament playing too defensively.
Is family with you?
Yeah. Meg and Linda are here, and a lot of supporters from Stanford.
Meg, of course, is Tom Watson's young daughter, Margaret Elizabeth. They give her her full name. They call her Meg. His wife, Linda, is here and is pregnant. They're expecting another child in December. And, of course, it is Father's Day, most appropriately. There's the look down the first fairway to where the men will tee off. It's a reasonably short par four,
the
first hole here.
The fourth round. The referee is William C. Campbell, the president of the United States Golf Association from Huntington, West Virginia. The observer is Stephen J. Harrell, a member of the USGA Executive Committee from El Cajon, California. The special observer is Alistair Lowe, an official of the Royal and Ancient Golf Club of St. Andrews, Scotland. The players are Bill Rogers of Texarkana, Texas. And Tom Watson of Kansas City, Missouri. Mr. Rogers has the honor. Play away, please.
Play away on the first hole, 378 yards, a par four, slight dogleg to the right. Out of bounds on the left and on the right. Rogers off the tee.
Beautiful drive, Jim, right down the middle of the fairway.
That's the voice of Bob Rosberg out on the fairway. He'll be following this group. On the right side there, you see the shot that is presented to him now. Another group up ahead on the first green. Now Watson. Title of a song that Bing used to sing in his days here at the Crosby tournament. So the two leaders are safely off the first tee in the final round of the U.S. Open. As I said, we'll be following them all the way around. I'm Jim McKay reporting from our ABC commentary position, and what a leaderboard we have here. There's a story behind each and every golfer who has a chance to win this championship. Watson, of course, has never won the Open. Rogers has never won the Open. Jack Nicklaus trying for an unprecedented fifth. Cal Peet is on the leaderboard. He would be the first black American ever to win our national championship. David Graham trying to repeat. Bruce Devlin trying to win at age almost 40. Everyone a story, no matter who wins today. Let's bring in right now our resident expert on the sport of golf, as we always say, Dave Marr.
A big story to me this week, Jim, is the weather. In 72, when the Open was played here and Nicklaus won, the conditions got so tough the last day that he said during the round he felt like it almost wasn't golf. The greens got so hard. But now, the last 2 days, the wind down, as you said, the weather is very warm. The greens may be a little softer and hold a little better than the officials would like it, but all this is conducive to good scoring, and that's why you see so many under par, where in 1972 there wasn't any player under par. I look for a lot of, you got to get off to a good start here at Pebble Beach, and if there's ever a day you could attack Pebble, it's today.
Okay, well, we are talking a bit quiet. If it seems that we are mumbling a bit here, it's because there are players on the 18th green. Apparently, they can hear us today. Let's bring in now a man who will be sharing the basic commentary with me, my ABC colleague, Jack Whitaker.
Thank you, Jim. I think there's only been one surprise here, and that's been the weather, as David just said. Pebble Beach always has wind, and as the Scots say, nay wind, nay golf.
Aye, laddie.
But I think that the players are very happy it's this way. Other than that, it's been everything an Open should be. Exciting, record performances, and a lot of heartache. George Burns went out in 30, came home in 42 in the second round. We have the most attractive leaderboard. Nicklaus making a surge here. Watson and Rogers, two very classy players at the top. I'm so excited. I want to get to work.
It's not Jack's first U.S. Open, but it's the first one he's covered on television. So it'll be a good day for all of us, I think. Let it go back down to the fairways now for the second shots of the leaders on the first hole. There's the way they stand. David Graham has parred the first hole. Lanny Watkins at 2-under now. After four, Scott Simpson and Bruce Devlin. It's going to ebb and flow because there's a long, long way to go. There is the first green, well bunkered, as you see, right and left. Houses along the left side of the fairway. And Rogers here. You see his shot from his angle now. He's parred every day. Yes, Dave?
Great pin position here for Billy. It's in the back right of the green. And it's just make your mind up and pick the proper club there. Rossi, about how long a shot does he have there?
Well, Bill laid back a little, Dave. I think he probably hit a 3-wood or 4-wood off.
Looked like it.
He's about 155 yards. I'll tell you, this is really a treacherous shot. George Burns just hit a real good-looking second shot. At one time, it was about 12 feet from the hole and trickled down into the fringe and made six.
Made six? My goodness. You just don't want to hit it to the right here, Jim. Just aim at the middle of the green and let Bill's little left-to-right shot. Perfect kind of shot for him to have.
That's just what he's done with it. Right at the middle of the green.
Fine shot. Good shot by Bill Rogers. Now, one of the co-leaders safely on that first green. As you said, Dave, you've got to get off to a good start here, or it'll eat you alive, wind or no wind.
If you're going to score, you have to do it in these first six or seven holes, especially with the lack of elements against the players.
Looks like Tom's on the edge of a divot hole there. Didn't bother him.
Got it going just to the left of the flag. Good-looking shot.
Two fine shots by the co-leaders on the first hole. Still haven't met all of our commentators here. Once again, we're going to have Peter Alice from overseas with us and Frank Hannigan representing the USGA. So, Peter, why don't you say a hello to us today?
Well, over the next 4 hours, we could see some dramatic happenings here at Pebble Beach. Many people in contention, famous names, and some perhaps not quite the family names that we know in the world of golf. We're going to follow their fortunes right the way through, and two of those players, well, their fortunes I'm going to watch particularly carefully. They're both Australian. The defending champion, David Graham, not for 30-odd years has a defending champion returned successfully to hold his title for the second year. Bruce Devlin, another Australian, well, he hasn't won anything for 10 years. Can he hold on? I think the answer is yes, although there are many great names lurking, and none greater than Jack Nicklaus, going for his 20th major title, going for his fifth Open Championship. What a day it promises to be. And we're going to follow them for 4 hours and see maybe their whole lives change before our very eyes. With us again, Frank Hannigan, as usual, of the United States Golf Association, is going to help us on the rules and any problems we might get into. Frank, unique place to come to a public course for the championship.
The only public course in the history of the U.S. Open Championship, Peter. But the U.S. Open can be played on any golf course as long as it's a great golf course. Now, of course, it's public in the sense that it is what we call a place of public accommodation. Anyone can come in and play. If you stay at the hotel here, the lodge, it's a certain fee. If you just walk in off the street, it's a $70 green fee. So while it's a public golf course, it's not exactly a playground for the proletariat either.
Well, it's a beautiful place, and let's go and see some of the beauty with Jim McKay. Back to more golf.
Okay, Peter and Frank, back to the first green. Now, our roving announcers today will be Bob Rosberg, whom you've already heard. He's with Watson and Rogers. John Schroeder is up ahead with David Graham and George Burns. And Ed Snead is with Jack Nicklaus and Cal Pete. So, I think we're well covered on all fronts here as we rove the fairways of Pebble Beach and move down course to Jack Nicklaus with a birdie attempt at the third hole. He could use this right now, having bogeyed the first. He's at even par for the championship, four shots out of the lead. Third hole, a dogleg par four. less than 400 yards.
Could this be the beginning of the Bears' charge?
It could.
Well, he has to get something started, because when you make 5-5 the first two holes of Pebble, you've really given two strokes up to the field, and that's not a good start.
Second hole being a par 5, of course. Now back to Rogers and his birdie attempt on the first hole. So Nicklaus is at 1-under again. And Rogers, he makes the little one. He'll remain at 4-under. So Nicklaus is 3 back, pending the putt of Tom Watson.
Watson gets a little help there, Jim, with the fact that he's almost on the same line that Bill was. And that's a funny first green to putt, really. It takes a lot of knowledge on these greens. They don't always go like they look. So he saw Bill's ball there make a little move to the right, and he's sort of putting up the hill. Mm-hmm. So he's got a very, very makeable putt here. Good second shot in there.
I'm sure you've noticed that Bruce Devlin has picked up a birdie and has moved within a shot of the lead.
Well, he was due to make a birdie. Went all day yesterday without one.
That's right.
And that can happen to a lot of players.
So, Watson and Rogers apparently will both par the first hole. Bill has yet to put his in. Let's make sure of that.
A tricky little putt, too. You know, this about 2 feet there.
It's already tightening up. Watson and Rogers, then Devlin only one shot back, and Lanny Watkins moving into that tie at 2-under with David Graham and Scott Simpson, and Cal Pete at 1-other with Lon Hinkle and Nicklaus. Wow. They're all off in play in the U.S. Open, with the co-leaders parring the first hole. Watson and Rogers moving on, and we'll be seeing all of these leaders. We'll also be seeing past champions.
That's how they stand as we commence the final round of the 82nd United States Open Championship. Watson and Rogers there, Devlin with a birdie, creeping up on the leaders. Fine view over this marvelous course. We find the third fairway. Here's Bruce Devlin, who led the first 2 days, had all sorts of problems yesterday, but making a nice, confident start to his final round. 3-under, birdied the last hole, which is the 506-yard par 5. This one, 394 yards, and the flag pretty well back and tucked away in the right corner. There you see Devlin from the perfect position on the fairway has got to come over the bunkers and just get it right. And played a very good shot indeed. Could have done with a little bit more if you're looking for perfection, but really there's not much margin for error there. And he'll be relatively pleased with that one. Playing with Devlin, Scott Simpson. Rather mechanical, wooden swing, but a very good temperament indeed. Good solid game. Just watch them. Wide swing. Tall young man. And a good shot from Simpson. So both of them with outside chances for birdie threes. Marvelous crowd here today watching these great players. And we'll drop to the second green. David Graham, the defending champion. These pictures going already down to Australia on Channel 9 and through New Zealand. A lot of people up late there in Clarinda Street and South Yarra watching their favorites, I'm sure. There's Graham, who played such a marvelous final round last year in this championship. Taking his time as ever. Now Jack Nicklaus. Second shot to the fourth. Dropped a stroke at the first, didn't get a birdie at the second, birdied the third. Now with this simple-looking little pitch, up to the fourth green.
Peter, he's got to be careful not to put too much spin on this ball. And he's hit it nice and low right at the flag.
Well, could have done with one more bounce there. Now, back to the second, David Graham. Awkward little chip. Just gives it a little step. Just caught the edge of the slope. And you saw what happened. Just kicked it away. David Graham, who's been coached, if that's not too strong a word, this week by Phil Rogers. Now then, Cal Pete, second to the fourth. Interesting swing, because he's got a bad arm, Cal. Can't really straighten on his arm, rather reminiscent of the great Abe Fergal from years ago. And look at that ball spinning back. He really has peppered the flag, both yesterday and the previous rounds. Hardly hold a putt. And Pete still very much in contention in this championship. At one under. Watson and Rogers, though, still leading. At four under. Bruce Devlin now at the third. Quite a long putt. Not a bad effort from there. Get it up 14 inches or so from the hole, making a nice, smooth, confident start. David Graham now putting for a birdie at the second. Little tap, and in she goes. Graham goes to three under, and he's not giving up that crown without a great fight. It's over 30 years since a champion defended the title, and that was great Hogan. Burns, George Burns, just taps his in, also gets a birdie. So Burns, who figured so prominently in this championship last year, is right in the thick of it again this year. Now Scott Simpson, putting for a three at the third. This to go three under. Well, nice and tidy. Now, Rogers, Bill Rogers, second to the second.
Ball's going right. It's going to be in the right rough, Peter. Short, very bad spot.
Well, there's the voice of Bob Rosberg telling us, our pictures illustrating how Rogers has cut that away to the right, and he really doesn't appear to have very much hope of getting down in two from there. But this is a par five, so all is not lost if you don't birdie the hole.
On the other hand, you feel that you're losing something if you don't birdie it. It really plays like a very, very long par four.
Tom Watson's second shot.
That was not a good shot at all, Peter. He just had a three iron at the green, really hit it very thin in the right-hand bunker.
Well, a little bit of pressure, and there's plenty of that here today, taking its toll. I'm always rather interested when people sort of say they're going to go out and attack the course. I think you just do the best you can. Here's Nicklaus for a birdie at the fourth. And it turning, it's in. Well, Jack's wearing green sweater today, and he's obviously not superstitious. Perhaps it's the Irish blood in him. What a start, my word, word. Dropped one at the first, didn't get a birdie at the second, and then 3-3. Nicklaus is on the move.
Jack Nicklaus on the fifth tee. Par three, 170 yards. He has birdied the third and fourth after an opening bogey and is two shots off the lead.
Okay.
boy, does he respond to the pressure, Dave, doesn't he?
Well, Jack, that's why he's already won 19 majors and more money than anyone else that's ever played. And I just didn't know how he'd be after bogeying the first hole and not birdieing that second. But you've got to drive a stake in that man to make him quit trying. I'll tell you, he's tough.
Oh, let's take another look, Dave. Good looking swing. Jack Nicklaus that far away from his third straight birdie. Now we're live. Calvin Pete playing with Jack. And that is in the bunker, it appears. In that front bunker.
I said maybe I'll pull a Zello.
But the story right now on Pebble Beach, Jack Nicklaus. And there's his ball at this par three. Narrow uphill. Watson and Rogers still tied for the lead at four under. Playing on the second hole now. Graham and Devlin at three under. Nicklaus, Watkins, and Simpson at two under. George Burns, Rinker, and Calvin Pete at one. And the rest at even. Still a very crowded leaderboard. All of these people realistically have a chance to win this tournament. We have Bill Rogers now at the second hole. This is his fourth shot and on the par five. And he has been putting like an angel. And we have a little trouble report here. David Graham, John Schroeder, what's happening out there?
Well, Jack, David pulled his tee shot and it caught the last pine at the edge of the fairway. He got a good break in the sense that it came down in a bunker where he's got a nice clean lie. And as a matter of fact, he's got an unobstructed line to the flag. He has two problems, however. One is the hill right in front of him, so he has to get the ball up quickly. And the other, he may have a restricted backswing because of the tree overhanging the trap.
And just hooked his drive a little too much. This is what he sees, and it's a blind shot for David, I guess, and all of that. But that branch hanging down there, he's checking that now. Can he get it up fast enough and then hit it far enough, John?
Oh, yes, I think so. He's using a lofted club, probably an 8 or 9 iron. It looks like he's aiming a little right, too.
Mm-hmm.
See, he's got to bring the club inside so he won't hit that branch at the top of his backswing.
Defending champion, only one shot off the lead.
Oh, he's half shanked it, Jack.
And disappears in that rough.
Not in good shape at all to try to save par.
That's the shot he'll have for his third. Pin pretty close. Defending champion David Graham at the third hole. For George Burns. Playing on the last day with David Graham for the second year in a row. Same time, same place next year.
George Burns shanked that ball.
Oh,
out of bounds.
My, oh, my. George has had the most mercurial U.S. Open here. Jack, he got six on the first hole, a birdie on the second, and now
the ball hit a tree and came back in.
Back in, John? Does he have a shot?
Yeah, it came back in about 15, 20 feet inside the tree line, and he's not sitting. I can see the ball sitting in the rough from here, so he may have a shot.
Now let's move ahead to Tom Watson. Co-leader for a birdie. Yes, and now we have one leader, Tom Watson at five under par. So we're looking out across the bay there. Watson now will go a 5-under. And Rogers with that putt for par would remain at 4-under if he makes it at the second hole. A cloudy, overcast day again. Sun trying to break through. And very little wind. As we look up the 18th. And George Burns over at the third hole. Having just escaped a tragedy. Not going out of bounds. And David Graham in trouble at the same hole. John Schroeder, does David Graham have any kind of chance to get the ball on the green?
Jack, he can put it on the green, but how much he wants to aim at the flag is debatable. He's got a very, very heavy, tough lie, and he's got very little green to work with. And, of course, with that long grass, he can't spin it. And with these greens as firm as they are, he's got to hit way up in the air. In fact, he's not even going to reach the green. And he's still in the deep rough.
Yep, still in the deep rough.
That shows you how thick the rough is in places on this course this year.
So David Graham, the defending champion, is there in three. George Burns up on the hillside, going to take another look. Now here is Jack Nicklaus up at the fifth green for a birdie two, or his third birdie in a row. Two shots behind the leader, Tom Watson. Back at the third hole, George Burns. Third shot. On what really, David, is a nice-looking little par four, isn't it?
It may be little, but it's played hard all week, Jack.
Come down.
Oh, George Burns is not on the putting surface in three. That's Pebble Beach. The most placid-looking holes can just jump up and bite you. Now we look at our little jewel of a hole at number seven. This is Lanny Watkins on the tee.
Get down. Get down. Get
down. Oh, he is down in fine shape, is Lanny Watkins. Lanny having a good day. He is 2-under for the tournament and 2-under on the day. Now, Tom Watson at 5-under, Rogers at 4, then Nicklaus and Graham and Devlin, but Graham going to drop out of there soon. And Lanny Watkins, Scott Simpson. Bobby Clampett still in red figures. And Larry Rinker, the young man who was in second place after 36 holes, still hanging in there, along with Calvin Pete, Craig Stadler, Dan Pohl, and Lon Hinkle. These people not out of contention yet, although as the holes go on, they get further away from the leaders. We look down at that seventh hole here, the final round of the 1982 United States Open Championship. We'll be back in a moment.
We return live to Pebble Beach, where the battle is joined, and among those joining the battle, Bill Rogers, tied for the lead at the start of the day, now one shot behind the current leader, Tom Watson. Something bothering him there, Dave?
Well, not much. He's grinning. He just can't make his mind up. He's you're going back toward the ocean with his second shot, and maybe the wind has picked up a little bit, so he's changed clubs. Now, whether he went up a club or down a club, I don't know, but that's what he was grinning about, was a little indecision.
Well, this is the hole that bit David Graham and George Burns just a minute ago. Normally, not too difficult a hole. Pin placement today, tough.
Could hear
beautiful
say,
looking
get it
shot.
Win.
Mm. He, yeah. picked, he did take, he went back to the seven iron, David. He went from an eight to a seven, and he should have stayed with the eight, I guess.
Yeah.
Now, this was the putt for a bogey five by David Graham. Remember all the trouble he had on this hole. Needed this. to avert a six. Did he avert it? He did. David Graham hanging in there, hanging tough. Now at two under for the championship. Three shots out. Now, Tom Watson, live, second shot on the third, leading the tournament by a stroke.
Right at it.
But not long enough, Bob, in the bunker.
Well, he hit a nine iron after seeing that ball go over the green of Rogers. I guess he figured that it wasn't quite as long as it looked. It was a beautiful looking shot right on the play.
And that's the tricky part about that hole, Rossi. You don't get a good look at that second bunker there. You're looking at that first one, you don't realize how far across there it is.
So the leader in trouble. I said that the battle was joined, and at the moment it seems to be a case of the more the merrier. Look at the charging Nicklaus at three under, the charging Lanny Watkins now three under. He's just birdied the little seventh hole. David Graham still at two, as we said. Scott Simpson and Dan Pohl, the longest hitter out here today, probably. Bobby Clampett just needs a couple of birdies to get into the fight again. And Larry Rinker, and all these others here still on the leaderboard. Cal Pete has dropped down to even par. But my goodness, there is going to be a crowd coming to that back nine, it looks like.
Well, we had how many guys? 13 or 14?
We had 13 within four shots starting the final round today. Now the eighth tee with Lanny Watkins. This one of the most gorgeous holes in all the world of golf. It's a blind tee shot, interestingly enough, along the ocean up to the top of the hill. And then when you're on top of the hill, the second shot goes across this cove with the rocky shores below and the waves beating. And he is in the rough. It shortens the shot, but it'll be an interesting one.
Might shorten your swing. He's in the light rough there, Jim. Looked as though he has a good lie as we look at the second shot there, and it may be the most beautiful second shot in golf across the ocean into that green that sunk sort of into the hillside.
Guy wouldn't want to get much closer to the cliff than Lanny is.
Not even walking,
you
much less hitting it there.
Yeah. It's about a 100-foot straight drop to the rocks below. No fence.
I had dinner with Lanny last night, and he thought that, he said, if I can shoot 67 or 68, get to 5 or 4 under before those other guys, I can win this tournament.
Watson with the bunker shot on 3. Out, but just about. Not an attractive-looking shot.
Ball must have been buried there, yep. Jim, because when you don't follow through that way, it's usually you're just trying to skip it through the grass, and whether he's lucky or unlucky, I don't know.
Nicklaus, second shot on the par 5, sixth hole. There's water on the right. Quite a bit of water, as you can see.
But he can reach the green here.
And has he gotten home? Yes. Nicklaus home in 2 on the par 5. That long putt for an eagle. But a birdie, well, not a certainty, but a probability at this point. Jack Nicklaus making a little more history. Now back to Rogers. Remember, he flew the green after going from an 8-iron to a 7-iron on the third hole. How about this?
Shouldn't be too hard a shot. You're pitching back up the hill. It's almost the same shot that George Burns had. It's not going to be quite as quick. The ball is not likely to get away, as you can see there. Tom had a much harder shot coming down the hill.
Now, if Nicklaus gets even a birdie on the sixth hole and Watson makes a bogey here, we're going to have a tie for the lead. Conceivably, if Nicklaus, by any chance, made that immense putt he has, he could even take the lead. Bruce Devlin now for a birdie at the fourth hole. Almost 45 years old, hasn't won a tournament in 10 years, hardly ever even plays golf anymore. Says he plays 9 holes once a week with his 14-year-old son, has participated in 5 tournaments this year and done nothing. Look at him here. Look at this.
Stay
Look
up.
At this. Bruce
All
Devlin,
right.
4 under par. One shot out of the lead, pending the problem that Watson has. He could be in a tie for the lead in about a minute or so. Now, it depends, as we said, on this man. Lies 3 on the par 4 hole.
The putt that he has, Jim, is downhill, so it's going to be very fast, and looks like it breaks a lot from right to left. Now, if you know the green, and I'm sure Tom does, it does not break as much from his right to left as it looks. So it's hard sometimes to get yourself to say, well, it looks like it's going to break 3 inches, but I'm only going to play an inch and a half. And you got to take your time and just do what you know rather than what you see. Well, it swung away quite a bit there.
We now have a three-way tie for the lead. Watson, Rogers, and Devlin, pending the performance of Nicklaus on the sixth green, where almost certainly he will move into a tie. We could have a four-way tie for the lead in about 2 or 3 minutes. Stand by. And Lanny Watkins is stroke behind.
There's no more confident player when he gets going than Lanny Watkins, and he's having a fine year.
Won the PGA on this golf course in a playoff with Gene Littler. Now Rogers. The USGA couldn't look for more representative champions. I really mean that, than the people who are fighting for this title right now. Bill Rogers handled himself so well after winning the British Open last year. Tom Watson, matter of record, how he performs. Jack Nicklaus, Devlin, all of them. All right. He is in a tie for the lead. Rogers at 4 under. Watson needing this to be 4 under. Just where they started the day. But Devlin has gained 2 shots. And Nicklaus overall has gained 2. And looks to be gaining more. All right. Watson down with the bogey 5 on the 3rd hole. And these are the less troublesome holes in the golf course.
They're really not, though.
Supposedly.
Well, Tom evidently there between a 9-iron and an 8-iron. You picked a 9 after he saw Bill's shot, and that's the wrong club, so he needed to hit maybe an easy 8. I mean, you can look back later on at a lot of things and just wonder, why didn't I do that, as we watch Lanny's second shot here at number 8.
Is that a sight or not? Look at outlined against the blue June sky. Lanny Watkins made his charge.
He's a gutty player.
Mm-hmm.
Nope. Don't want to go over this green.
Long.
So much
fringe.
So much will depend on that lie, Jim, because going down that hill is really slick.
Now back to Nicklaus. This is the long eagle attempt on the par 5 sixth hole. This, then, to take the lead.
Did he hit it?
And that to move into a tie for the lead and make it a four-way blanket right now. Jack Nicklaus on another of the scenic holes here, the 6. You see the sea behind, and there's the way they stand. It's a three-way tie at the moment. Nicklaus almost ready to move in if he makes that shortish putt. Watkins on the back of the green on 8. David Graham, 2 under, Dan Pohl. Boy, that is a beautiful leaderboard. You know, some of the great names in the sport and all so close together on a golf course where you can make birdies and you can make double bogeys. So that it's going to be up and down all afternoon.
There's so much danger on every hole, whether it's water or boundaries or bunkers, or it's quite a golf course to have a national championship on. As we're looking at the 4th hole from the player's viewpoint, not much of a hole, 327-yard hole, something like that. And if you just looked at your scorecard, you'd say, well, these guys will eat this hole up. But there's not much green there. Green is smaller than my kitchen.
And again, you do have the sea on the right if you just decide to bend one too badly, and out bunkers out in the fairways, including a new pot bunker on the left side of the fairway.
And out of bounds to the left if you just bailed out too much to the safe side, or what looks safe. But here's a man that can usually drive it very straight.
You see it. There they cross the fairway bunker. Now Nicklaus, this to move into the tie for the lead, remember. It would be a birdie. His 4th in a row. He's had 4 birdies in a row for Jack Nicklaus. The record in the U.S. Open, 6. It was set the other day by George Burns. The day before yesterday. So there it is, the four-way tie. Nicklaus, Watson, Rogers, and Devlin one stroke behind. Lenny Watkins, he's playing the eighth hole, as you see. David Graham, Dan Pohl. And somebody other than them could still win this tournament. Lenny Watkins, could it be? Oh, there he is, surveying his next shot on this gorgeous eighth green. Can't see whether he's in the first or second cuts there, which would make a difference.
It would give him a different option on what kind of shot that he has to play. You can tell by how he swings at it, Jim, whether it looks like
this.
Looks as though it's down, so the ball will run anyhow because he's downhill. Big break right to left. Doesn't look like he's in the real tall stuff, though.
We're going way, way left. Look at this. Left himself a long putt for the par on the eighth hole. And that is the nature of Pebble Beach. Capricious. It gives, then takes away. Now, moving from the sixth green to the seventh tee is Jack Nicklaus, along with his fellow competitor, Cal Pete. 110 yards, off on a half a wedge, but on a very windy day, a long iron. True, sir?
Absolutely, but today it's calm.
That's right.
Sure, it's not more than a wedge or maybe a little nine. Noise you hear.
Crowd here at 18 has just seen that Nicklaus has birdied the last hole on the scoreboard.
The bear is loose.
Another makeable putt. Jack Nicklaus looking at his son, talking to his son, who is his caddy, on Father's Day. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. And Bill Rogers, second shot, fourth hole. Up and at the flag, and a gem. Wonderful shot. Tom Watts playing with Rogers, both four under. And you saw how small a shot Watson had to play there. Just too much spin, not really so good from that range. And just look at that for a view. Now you'd have to travel far and many a day by mule to get a better view than that. That famous little peninsula jutting out here, a little short seventh on the bottom left-hand side of this green, and sixth green, top middle, all round that majestic bit of coastline. It really is something. Quite marvellous. A little bit of breeze, not too much, and this man really going great guns. Let's hear from Ed Snead.
I talked, Peter?
Yeah, hello, Ed.
I was walking up the fairway on the right at six with Jack, and he had a very interesting comment up the hill. He had hit his last three golf shots, and especially commenting on the two at six. And it's obviously charged up, and I think, as everyone can see with four straight birdies, he would be charged up, but it's making those putts has obviously changed him a little bit. He seems to be much more aggressive than he was early in the tournament.
Well, Nicklaus for a two at the seventh. This is for his fifth birdie in a row. And if this goes in, what a cheer, and he will be in the lead. Has he? What a man. Five in a row, dropped a stroke at the first hole, didn't get a birdie at the second, where most players were and would expect to get a birdie, and then just five in a row. Well, well, well.
Peter, in the first three rounds, Nicklaus had 16 putts within 15 feet for birdies and made four of them. Looks like he's going to get it all back today.
Well, good day to do it. Here's a man putting for a birdie. This to tie with Nicklaus at five under, if you can get it in. And I think we're having one of the great, great golfing days. It's slowly back, taps it in. Rogers, Nicklaus, 5 under. Well, Rogers marches away, and Nicklaus doing great stuff up ahead. Well, we asked the great man himself, Nicklaus, how he thought the USGA set up the courses for this championship.
I think the last couple of opens, the golf course has been set up very well. They've been very fair. They've not tried to gimmick up the golf course or do things that were really shouldn't be there. And I don't expect them to do that at Pebble Beach. I think Pebble Beach will be set up very well, and that I think they've gotten over the thought that gee, we have to make preserve par at all costs. Good gracious, the fellas today are much better than the guys were 20 years ago, and 30 years ago, 40 years ago. The fellas today can really play golf. Not to say the guys couldn't play golf, but the level of competition is so much greater, and it forces the fellas to shoot so much lower that if they shot 289 at Augusta 10 years ago, we'll certainly shoot lower. I mean, at Pebble Beach 10 years ago, we'll shoot lower this time. I don't think there's any question about that. And I think it's the same everywhere. And it's the same in all sports. So I think as long as you... I think the British took the tact on it the right way first. The British Open, they've set it the same way for years and years and years. They don't really change it very much. They pretty much play the same golf course. And oh, occasionally they'll make some changes, but nothing to amount to anything. And they've let the golfers' scores speak for themselves, and the scores have started to come down substantially in the British Open, only because I think the golfers are better.
Oh, interesting words there from the mighty Jack Nicklaus. And he and his partner, Pete, coming up the hill at the eighth. Nicklaus and Rogers, 5 under par, leading the way, but great names not far behind. Nicklaus, just 5 birdies in a row. And it really is scintillating stuff. Still lots more holes to be played, of course. Some spectacular ones. 8, 9, and 10 here, arguably the three most difficult, best, most challenging par fours in the world. And if you're taking more than four, you can always stop and admire the view, which is quite breathtaking. Watkins, Annie Watkins. Ninth hole, second shot. Dropped a stroke at the eighth. And that looks very good indeed. Very aggressive player, quick swing. Doesn't hang about much, Lanny. Playing very well this year. And a chance, very holeable putt at this ninth hole to go back to 3 under. Bill Rogers. Now just got to get his tee shot through the trees, uphill, 170 yards, 5 iron or so, that sort of club for Bill. Cries a little too strong, right on line, and he'll be wondering why the crowd at the green aren't going berserk. The answer is a little strong. Kyle Watson will know from the crowd's reaction by the green that that ball is not close, and he knows that it's too far. Quickly though to the seventh, there's Devlin back to Watson, and he's also urging it to get down. And yes. Okay, Tom. Here's Devlin, recorded at the seventh. Just this little shot down the hill. Tiny little shot today. Oh, 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 oh. Well, sitting up all right. not the most difficult bunker shot there for Devlin. That's the green, bottom left, that Devlin's just played to. Just look how those bunkers nestle round. Sixth coming down on the left. That's the 13th, 14th, up the hill, and here's Nicklaus. Having played an iron from the tee at the 8th, going through his now very familiar routine, lining everything up. Still quite a long way to go, this hole 433 yards.
Peter, he's a little downwind here. I would imagine he's got a 5 or a 6 iron, and I had to guess with the adrenaline flowing a little bit, he's probably going to go with a 6.
On the right, not one of Jack's best shots, but it could be stuck in that thick rough not far from the flag. Not a good shot from Jack. He wouldn't, if that club selection of 6 iron, as Ed Sneeds and Ed suggested, was right, he wouldn't be wanting to miss the green with that. Seventh green, Devlin second, little splash from the bunker. Well, bunker's quite deep. That was a little heavy-handed, awkward shot. Devlin, I think, has kept his game going remarkably well for a man who's competed very little. He's played 4 or 5 tournaments this year, really not played very well. He's always played a few tournaments every year, been a great supporter of Australian golf, and I know a lot of his friends and relations down there will be urging him on. And that was a poor tee shot from Bruce. Look at that now, looking down on the ninth, Watkins, to go 3 under. This for a 3. And looks... Oh, just didn't stay up. Has to settle for a 4. Dropped a stroke at the 8th, but still 2 under par. Under for the day. So the first 9 completed for Watkins. We'll go back and have a look. Bill Rogers on the 5th, back of the green. Defending champion David Graham still there, 2 under, 3 behind the leaders. Well, Rogers' confidence must be flowing through his veins. Flag out. Lots of little mannerisms, Bill. Aims well left, as you can see. Tall, skinny fella. Mallet-headed putter, slow backswing, tap. Well, it's a good speed, but misread. Misread totally, and that's just galloped on a bit. Let's go to the 18th and hear from Jim McKay.
Okay, Peter, thank you very much. If you've just joined us, I'm sorry to say you already have missed quite a bit. You know, from time to time, people say to us that maybe 18 holes is a sort of overkill. Will people sit still for 4 hours? Well, if we hadn't been here the first hour today, what we would have missed? The charge of Jack Nicklaus. He bogeyed the first hole. He then parred the second hole, which is normally a birdie hole for him. In other words, he had given away 2 strokes to par on holes where you're supposed to get it back. And then it happened. He birdied 5 holes in a row and has now taken the lead in this U.S. Open Golf Championship. So the story of the first hour is very simply Jack Nicklaus going for an unprecedented 5th U.S. Open Championship and for his 20th major championship, an almost unbelievable record. We have the story of Bruce Devlin. He was 2 under at the end of yesterday, and everybody said, well, at the age of almost 45, that's really a terrific performance for him, no matter what happens on Sunday. Well, he's 3 under on today's round. just lost one stroke. We're told so that he is now two under. And that is the way it has been ebbing and flowing back and forth with the one dominant thread, Jack Nicklaus. Okay, Peter.
Thank you, Jim. And you can see Nicklaus there perched on the edge of the bunker. Very awkward shot indeed. He's got to have a long enough swing and give it enough hit to make sure of getting the ball out. And he's played it as well as he could, had to give it a stab, hope for the best. And he's got a chance of well, look at it, still rolling down the hill. And hurry up, mark it, Jack, that's it. Wait till it stops. Jim McKay mentioned that Devlin had dropped a stroke to par. He'd gone back to just four under for the championship. This was his putt for a par at the seventh. Remember, he was in the sand and he putted it up and just didn't get it quite enough, and that was a stroke dropped by Devlin at the seventh. Rogers at the fifth for par three. And he's done it again. Remains five under. Rogers has holed out quite beautifully, as well as hitting the ball very straight. He's had a couple of very long putts go in. And he looks very calm and relaxed, I must say. Watson to remain four under. Yep. It really is a sensational day so far, and there's lots more to come. So much can happen over the closing holes. Someone can have a spurt, as Nicklaus did, and had five in a row. Here's Dan Pohl, 10th tee. Only two behind, three under par, and cracks one away down the left side. This fairway slopes left to right. Cliffs and the ocean on the right-hand side, and there's another green perched at the end there.
It was Pohl, of course, who played that great back nine in the fourth round at Augusta to catch Stadler, and then only to lose in the playoff.
Annie Watkins. Oh, oh, now. And he's up in the thick stuff. Maybe fortunate to have some sort of lie, but that was a bit quick and a bit hurried, and he paid the penalty. A marvelous stretch of sand at the bottom of the cliffs there, and the rollers coming in. Nicklaus and Rogers then. Five under. The pack nipping at their heels. Now, Nicklaus nearly got away with that iron shot to this green, just fell away, chipped it out here, and what a sensation it would be if he could hold this one, because this would really calm him down. Forgot to hit it. Now he'll be cross with himself there, because although he's had such a great run of five birdies, he was in the ideal position on top of the hill, and as Ed Snead told us, with the wind behind, it was quite a short middle iron, missed the green and ended up by dropping a stroke to par. So Rogers is ahead by one, all by himself. It's the 82nd Open, and there's a lot of golf to be played yet.
Jack Nicklaus at the ninth tee, tied for second place now with Watson and Devlin at four under.
He's down the right side, Jack.
Yeah.
I can't tell if he's in the rough. I think he's just into the rough on the right side over the hill, about where he was yesterday.
You can see the ball a little, but we never know. Dan Pohl, his second shot here at the 10th hole. Another long par four, and he's on nicely. Very narrow opening, as you see here at 10, and a treacherous right side there. Now the leader on the sixth hole, Bill Rogers' second shot at par five. Climbing up the hill. And in good position.
Jack, that ball is absolutely perfect as far as position is concerned, but it came to rest in a divot up here.
Oh, no, Rossi, really?
It's not a bad-looking divot, but the ball is down.
The rub of the green, huh? All right, Tom Watson. Any wind out there, Rossi?
Just a little into the players. Tom can get there, though. He hit a big drive.
Cut.
Got it coming a little left. I believe it jumped into the bunker.
Yes, left bunker. Right up green side, though, and there it is. It'll require a nice explosion shot by Watson. Par five, sixth hole. Well, with about half the field completed today, we only have five rounds under par. Here's Gary Koch, who is one under and five under for the day. He had nine birdies yesterday, and he's had a whole slew of them today. And he puts it just at the edge. Six birdies today and nine yesterday. 67 if he pars this. He's two putts from about 50 feet here at 18. He's tied with Danny Edwards, Calvin Pete, and Bobby Clampett at one under. As we look down from the blimp at this gorgeous piece of topography, White Beach of Carmel. And Craig Statler at one over. Through seven holes. Raymond Floyd is finished at 10 over. Tom Kite. And Miller and Tom Weisskopf, who had a hole in one today at the seventh hole. The second time he's done that in the U.S. Open. Dale Irwin through 15. And the sun trying to break through, but so far unsuccessfully. But it's a brighter day today. But of course, playing a little harder, I guess, David, because the greens are a little firmer, aren't they?
They have to be. No precipitation last night, so not enough wind to dry them out and make them real firm, though, Jack.
Bill Rogers, the leader by one at the sixth hole, third shot. Sitting up there nice, Rossi, hmm?
Well, not exactly, Jack. It's sitting just in, in the front edge of the divot. He really, he can pinch it, though. Looks long.
Did he pinch it enough? All right, that's what he has left. As we turn now to Jack Nicklaus' second shot at nine.
He's going to have to be going with about a 7 or an 8 iron, depending on how much the ball is going to fly. He cannot hold this green from the position he's in. He's got a flyer in the rough, and he's on a downhill lie. I think he'll have to let the ball bounce up. He's carried it into the green.
And as you said, it's really rolling through it. Comes to rest right by Calvin Pete's ball. The back edge, right up against the rough, the fringe. Think like semicolons. Oh, that's Jack Nicklaus, one shot behind the leader. Look at that ninth hole. That is really a terror. 9 and 10. Well, Bill Rogers at five under, Nicklaus and Watson, and Bruce Devlin at four under. Now here's Mr. Watson. It's from the trap.
Oh.
not really a very good shot, Jack. Oh. It was a long blast, but he had a beautiful lie, and he's really disappointed with hitting a shot like that. He left it probably 18 feet short.
Here's Gary Koch at 18 and makes a beautiful first putt, but it does go by a little. He needs that to come back now for a par here to be at 69 for the day. One under on the tournament. Bill Rogers surveying the territory here. Player of the year last year, winning at Heritage and British Open, World Series of Golf. For Rogers. Boy, he has been putting so beautifully. And he has that just left there for par to remain at 5 under. A little earlier, we asked Bill if he had done anything and prepare himself to play this well.
Because I haven't done anything previous to indicate that I was going to play well here. But I know that funny things happen at major championships. It's a different kind of atmosphere. It's a different kind of everything. You know, it's a golf course that, you know, if you hang around par or a little bit under, that you know you're going to be in the thick of things. And so you work hard, you struggle hard, you scramble hard, and that's what I've done this week. I played good 2 out of the 3 rounds, and the other round I was able to scramble well.
Thus spake Bill Rogers. As we look at Tom Watson, the clause is at 18 here, where Gary Koch has just made par for a 67, not a 69. 1 under for the tournament. Now Watson, this is Watson remain one behind Bill Rogers as they go to the short seventh. Here now on the 18th, moments ago, Gary Koch. 78, 73, 69 yesterday. And 67 today. One under for the tournament. Now David Graham. This is for birdie at the 8th at the par 3 7. Defending champion. Hello. And David gets up down to 3 under, just 2 shots off the lead. Our follow Calvin Pete and Jack Nicklaus up at the 9th green. Jack, who ripped off 5 birdies in a row and then bogeyed the 8th hole to momentarily slow up. David, what do you do here when it's up against the fringe? You pray a lot, don't you?
You sure do. Well, he must be able to feel like he's going to get the putter on the ball. A lot of times, players here will use a sand iron and play sort of a little skull shot. You see where he's... Yeah. Where he's dressing it, he's going to try to hit it in the middle. A lot of players will do that with sand iron. It's an awkward shot, and not one that you practice very often, but you should, because you get a lot of these in an open. Better start slowing down.
Yes. Slow. Well, he'll have that for par and probably get a read from Calvin Pete if that was his ball mark next to it. Jack started out with a bogey and a par, 5-5, and then went five birdies in a row, and then a bogey at 8. But he's in it, one stroke behind Bill Rogers now. As we come to the 7th tee, and Tom Watson, who's also at 4-under. Seventh. Oh. That would give him a tie. Moments ago here at the same hole, the leader, Bill Rogers. And he finds the bunker. So we may have a change in the leaderboard here at the 7th hole, with Watson up snug, looking to birdie 2. Bill Rogers in the bunker. Jack Nicklaus up at 9 with a long putt for par, or medium putt for par anyway. As we show you the other scores, George Burns at 1-under with that group. Here's Nicklaus now for the par. Yes, in. Remains one behind the leader for the time being. David, when you get that momentum going as he had, and that adrenaline pumping, and then all of a sudden slow up, is it a little difficult to get it going again?
But Jack realizes that 8, 9, and 10, if you can go through there without any disasters happening to you, you're not, but he's actually, you can almost say he's tied for lead simply because he's played 8 and 9, and if you can go 4-4 there, you deserve the lead, which is what either Watson or Rogers will have to do if he can get out of the bunker and Tom makes his. That's the stretch of holes that's going to set you round up, Jack, as to what you're able to do the rest of the way home.
There's David Graham at the top, second shot at 8. Cross the abyss and into the bunker, it appears. John Schroeder, are you out there? Let's go back the first snow to the 7th hole, and the leader at the moment, Bill Rogers, from the bunker. Remember, Watson has put it up just about 2 feet away. Steady. Oh, he's put that all the way across the green. We look down here at Tom Kite at the 18th. There's the leaderboard, which is going to change in a moment. As Bill Rogers is, looks to be about 30 feet away for par at the 7th hole. Jay Haas at 1-under now. Larry Rinker, the young man who was in second place after the 36-hole mark, is now 2-over. Crenshaw, 2-over. Peter Oosterhuis, who passed 50 people yesterday with a 67. Now, the leader at the moment for par at the 7th hole. Oh, he's done it again. How many times have we seen him do this, David, to save par with long putts like that?
But he's a streaky putter, Jack. Oh. When he gets going, he might just run the table on you, and then all of a sudden, you don't hear of him, and it's always his putting.
This is Dan Pohl now, who is 3-under. Just 2 shots off the lead. Oh, beautiful shot at the 11th hole. And that's a, looks like a makeable putt. Tommy Watson now to tie Bill Rogers. That's for birdie at the 7th. Well. Well, that's like a punch right in the nose, isn't it?
Certainly is, especially after Bill made his.
Jack Nicklaus. The long 10. A little trouble with his drive at 9, but this one is in the fairway.
Big position, Jack.
Thank you. He corrected the driver then right away, too, didn't he?
Well, he's been hitting the ball pretty solid all day, I think. He's a couple of the drives were marginal, but they just took a bad bounce or so. He's really hit the ball very solid all the way.
Now we get to the 8th tee with Bill Rogers sinking a long putt to hold par and Tom Watson missing a short putt for birdie. Do something to your psyche, huh?
It's happened to anyone that's ever played golf, Jack.
Uphill. Aim for the chimney on the Firestone house. Well, he looks perfect, Rossi.
Yes, that is about as good as you can do. That's the short way, and you really have a little easier shot coming in that way, away from the bunker and the ocean.
There's the chimney that they tell you to aim at from that 8th tee, and there's Tom Watson, his tee shot on the way.
Also perfect, a little more left, a little better angle to get it close, I guess, but a little more dangerous.
So, Bill Rogers leading this at 5 under, Jack Nicklaus and Tom Watson and Bruce Devlin all at 4 under. We'll be back with more in a moment.
There's the way they stand in the final round of the U.S. Open at Pebble Beach. Bill Rogers, the current British Open champion, by a single stroke over Jack Nicklaus, who has been charging Tom Watson and Bruce Devlin, hanging on at the age of almost 45. Then David Graham, the defending champion, long driving Dan Pohl, Bobby Clampett, who was raised around here, is making a little comeback. Just behind there, maybe that's a dad and his son on Father's Day, out in a little rubber raft in the waters of Carmel Bay. That could be the same situation. Good view of the golf course. Might as well take just a moment to look at that as Jack Nicklaus tests the breeze out on the golf course. Ed Snead, is there much of a breeze out there?
Jim, it's blowing a little bit from right to left as Jack is going to play this shot, which would make it maybe a little more difficult to get close to the pin, but it's an easier shot to play safely with that wind. If the wind were blowing left to right and you hit a bad shot and let it leak to the right, then it could be disastrous. But I think he's got a pretty good play to get close here.
If by chance you've just joined us, Nicklaus bogeyed the first hole, parred the second, then birdied 5 in a row. Picked up another bogey. 1-8, as you see. 33, 3 under par going out. He only had 2 pars in the front, if you notice. This is second on the 10th hole. That's a little gorge. He's going across there. Short putt. He'll be putting. You hear the waters lapping the shore. People with all kinds of vantage points down on the rocks. Bruce Devlin, unfortunately, has made a double bogey at the 9th hole. So that'll drop him out of the 3-way tie for second and drop him down to 2 under for the championship. Now, on the 8th hole, the gorgeous shot across the ocean. Bill Rogers leading the tournament. I was trying to get through the book, Dave. It looks to me like the last man to hold the British Open and U.S. Championships at the same time was Lee Trevino back in 71. Because he did them in the same year, this would be carrying over from last year.
Quite an accomplishment, no matter how you did it, if you have both.
Any way you manage. There you see it, short of the green, Bill Rogers. Last hole, he was in the bunker, but as you pointed out, these are the ones you really have to get past. And then got some nothing.
Then you have some tough ones finishing up. It's got 18 of the best finishing holes I've ever seen here.
Okay, now Tom Watson, stroke behind. Across the sea, down to the land, and on the green.
He may not stay, though.
Had a great opportunity on the last hole. That didn't back up quite enough to go off, I don't think. Great opportunity. There could have been a two-stroke swing there with Rogers in the bunker and Watson with a short putt for a birdie, but it didn't turn out that way. Rogers getting down and Watson missing the putt. Such is the game of golf. Watch the edge of that cliff if you ever play here.
You don't want to do any evil Knievels near that cliff.
No. There you see how much of a breeze there is at the eighth hole there as they come along. It's not Pebble Beach wind, not in any way, shape, or form. Now look from high overhead. This must be the blimp. Yes, we got the blimp up today. Too foggy yesterday. Goodyear Blimp Columbia from Los Angeles, piloted by Captain Joel Chamberlain from Norwood, Massachusetts. Yet another camera position. We've added them on again this year from 10 years ago when we were here. Looking down at the holes that run along the coast there. Now Cal Pete. Cal Pete, one under for the championship. That's where he started the day. Played very consistent golf during this tournament, 71, 72, 72. And even again today. Nice touch that man has.
He's a marvelous player, Jim. If there's any point of his golf game that's a little weak, it's the putting. And yesterday when he was finishing, he just hit a lot of really fine shots in a row at the last few holes and never did get one in.
By actual statistics, last year he led the PGA Tour in fairways hit in regulation, fairways hit and greens hit in regulation. This year he still leads in fairways, in his tee shots, and is second in greens in regulation only to the man you see at the top of the screen. Look at that. Won the amateur here, the open, three Crosbys. This could be Jack's sixth victory on this golf course. He's got to catch Rogers, as you see. It's all displayed for Dan Pohl, inching up the board.
What a nice young man he is, Jim. Long hitter, too. Fine player, lost to Stadler in a playoff this year at Augusta.
Mm-hmm. Sailboat passes by. We return to the cliffs overlooking Carmel Bay and Carmel Beach. And to Nicklaus.
It should break from Jack's left to right.
Son Jack holding the flagstick. Good college player at North Carolina. Pulls the pin for Dad, and let's see it. However, now Bill Rogers with his third shot on the eighth. Remember, he left it short, coming across the sea.
But that's where to be if you don't, if you're not on the green. Short here leaves you a much easier little pitch up the hill.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, he'll be coming down with that little one. Now made a long one on the last hole. So. Putter has not been errant so far. Very appealing. 31-year-old touring golf professional from Texarkana, Texas. Now we were on the eighth hole. We're going to move along the sea now from the blimp to the 10th hole, past the ninth. Now we had the blimp before. This is the one in the boat, Dave, that we also added this year. Rock steady too, isn't it? Amazing. Got some kind of a new mount for it. All along the 10th fairway. So you were at 8, 9, 10, and now from the ABC Sports Navy, we'll zoom in. People are walking along the beach. Every time we come here, it's remarkable to me that they don't even look up. Yeah. Cal Pete. Safely in, one under still. Still within striking distance. You have to get moving pretty soon, though. It's four shots behind. Nicklaus for the par. Watson on eight. That's his third shot. He's left himself something. Nicklaus safely in. Okay. So Jack moves on to the 11th hole. He's four under for the championship, three under for the day. And fascinating golf yet to come as he moves along. He'll go inland for a bit and then come back to the sea for the final two holes. Again, there it is. Rogers, Nicklaus, and Watson. Pole by himself in fourth place at the moment. David Graham, Bobby Clampett, Bruce Devlin. The two Australians are now tied. three shots off the lead. As we come back to Rogers and Watson. Boy, I can't imagine playing across that ocean there when the wind was howling against you. Have you ever done that?
I've tried to, I'll say that. But you aim way left in that case, Jim.
Yeah.
Crucial thing here for Tom Knight. Just missed a very short putt, about half this length, it looked like, at the seventh hole for birdie. Now he has to try to wiggle this one in for a par here at eight. And a tough kind of putt for a right-handed player in that it breaks left to right. If you miss this one, you wonder what you have to do to try to win the Open.
Nobody's ever figured out why that's tough, but it is. I know what you mean. He managed it.
Believe me, that was a big putt for his round. Yes, they all are, obviously.
Even par for the day, as you see. Four under for the championship. Stroke out of the lead. He'll watch and wait. Rogers putts. One would hardly call this a tap-in.
That is not, and if he should happen to let it get away from him, he's, as you said, he's now putting downhill. Could wiggle on by just as far as he is there. That's why you should put everything out, Jim. We shouldn't have any gimmies.
Mm-hmm. So these are all familiar when you get to a tough spot. Yeah.
Really not sure.
Well, when he was uncertain out on the fairway in the third hole, he went from an 8-iron to a 7-iron that turned out to be the wrong one. All right.
Beautiful putt there.
That was not an easy putt at all, as you said. Bill Rogers still leading by one as he moves to the ninth hole to round out the front side of his round. One more hole. Now Nicklaus on the 11th tee. This hole, 382-yard par four. How would you characterize it?
Good driving hole. You want to stay up the left side. You cannot see the area where the ball lands. There's a bunker up there, James, just to the right of. You've got to stay away from the right side.
It's Nate. How's it look?
Jim, I'm not able to see where the ball is landing right now.
Okay, we've got it. Thank you, just the same, Ed. We do see it right in the middle of the fairway. Time for another break right now. There's how they stand. Byron Nelson won it just once in 1939.
Welcome back to the Open Championship, live from Pebble Beach, California. And what a great place and a great event and great players are all here. Here's Bill Rogers, leader by one, one under for the day. Beautiful drive down the ninth hole for Rogers. Position A. 11th fairway. Nicklaus's second shot.
He's got a 9-iron, Peter. It looks to be right at it.
Well, a little strong. Just
a little
goes
long
to the back of the green, Ed, but it's a very good shot indeed, and an outside chance for a birdie. Tom Watson's tee shot at the ninth. Moments ago, recorded for you.
All right.
Yes, good rhythm, good swing. Follows it rather anxiously. Will it stay on the fairway? Yes, it will. Rolls down and to the green at the end. Don't get many more spectacular sights in golf than that. Halo in. Former champion, of course. 18th finishing his round. Seven over par. And look at this green. This really is speeding up. Roger's second shot to the ninth. There you get a perfect view of what he's got to do. Starts it down the left.
Going at the fat part of the green to the right, Peter. He drove very short and had to hit a very, very long iron today. Watson probably hit it 80 yards past him.
Well, he's not so far from the flag. He obviously doesn't like it. It looked to be a low cutter, and as Bob Rosberg said, a short drive from the tee. Someone just arrived from Aberdeen, trying to elude payment at the gate, maybe. Sacrilegious thing to say about the Scots, but never mind. Rogers still leads the way at one under. But just look at those names right behind him. Gary Coke in with a 67. That's the best round of the championship today. Jay Haas at the 18th. He's also been having a good round. Started three over, now one over, so four under for today. This for a 67. That's good scoring, Frank. Eh?
Sure. You know, Peter, there's a tournament within a tournament for those up in front on the final day of the Open. They're thinking about two things. If they finish in the top 15, they're exempt from all qualifying for next year's Open. Finish in the top 16, they're eligible for invitations to next year's Masters.
So that's... Oh, I thought we were going to see a really super ending there. The Jay Haas wasn't to be, but still a very good round. Yes, these various forms of qualification play a very big part, don't they? Invitation to the championship next year and to the Masters. Make every shot worthwhile. Good round, 68. Watson, second to the ninth. How about that one? 11th green, Nicklaus. Rather a long way past with his second shot. Just one behind, tied with Tom Watson at four under. This to join Rogers at five under. Down it goes, look at it turn. See, the greens are speeding up, Frank. How many times have they cut today?
Just three times. That's a very fast putt going down that hill. He just tapped it.
Some friendly folk out on the rocks. Really is a fascinating place. You've got beautiful nature, a superb golf course, a nature reserve, and this man Nicklaus, oblivious to it all as he struggles on yet another of these 3.5-4 footers for a par to remain four under. He seems to wait so long, gets himself so still, then draws it back, taps it in. A little more upright stance this week, a little wider stance. Done it. Well, 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 this 11th hole, just 382 yards and a drive and a small iron for Nicklaus, but it cost him a stroke. And he little bit hot under the collar about that. Rogers. Just a little chip from the very fringe at the ninth. Third shot. Speedy. David Graham. Second to the tenth. Defending champion. Yeah, good shot. The greens here relatively small, but still very important to get, if you can, your ball on the right side of the green to give you an easier putt. Saw Nicklaus three putt at the 11th. It wasn't all that far from the hole. Rogers still that one stroke ahead. But now Watson with this putt for a birdie, this to join Rogers at 5 under. Missed a little tiny putt at the 7th. Watson for a 3. Well, the chances have been there over these last two or three holes for Watson. He's not managed to take them so far. Rogers has been hanging on marvellously well. And he's got to hold yet another putt if he's going to stay ahead of Watson and the pack. He's seen the line that Watson's ball took, but you wonder how many of these you can keep on holding. Nicklaus, 12th.
Peter, I think Jack was really dismayed that his second shot on 11 didn't hold the green. He's hit three or four shots that have hit and backed up, and I think he was very, very surprised that his ball went so far by. I think he's got a 3-iron here.
Middle of the green. Rogers then for his par at the 9th. And he's... No, just ran out of steam. So Rogers drops the stroke at the 9th, goes back to 4 under. And Watson now with a little putt to remain at 4 under. Well, any one of... Three or four players could still win this, maybe more. First, Watson has to get this in, Frank.
One of the great putters in the world by any standards, and he's not having a good putting day.
No.
Only one putt green in the first 9.
That's in. Another chance missed. Now it's Rogers and Watson tying for the championship at 4 under par. We'll be back with more golf.
Jack Nicklaus at the 12th green, despite dropping a stroke at the 11th, is still now only one shot behind the leaders, Rogers and Watson. How long is this, Ed Snead?
It looks like, Jack, that he's got a pretty good putt at it. You know, it's about 35 feet, but there shouldn't be a lot of break. Maybe it's a little bit right to left, but it's the kind of putt that he could give a little more of a run at, as opposed to the one that he just had at number 11.
That's very nicely up. Very close this final round of this Open. Rogers and Watson at 4 under, Nicklaus and Graham at 3, and now Dan Pohl at 3, Devlin at 2 under. And there's the par for Nicklaus at 12. To keep him at 3 under and one shot off the lead. Now we'll take you for an update to Jim McKay.
Okay, Jack, thank you very much. Well, the story of this golf championship on the final day so far still is centered around the man you just saw, Jack Nicklaus. Once again, if you've just joined us, he started off the day by bogeying the first hole, a comparatively easy par four. Then on the second hole, a par five, normally a birdie hole for him because it's a short par five, he made a par, a very bad start. He then birdied five holes in a row. He's picked up bogeys, however, along the line. In fact, in the first 11 holes, he's only had three pars. He's had five birdies and three bogeys. But there are so many other stories. There's David Graham, the defending champion, hanging on. And, of course, up on front, we have Bill Rogers and Tom Watson. They started the day tied for the lead. They've been going back and forth. I suppose the most significant thing between them came at the seventh hole, a little 110-yard par three. On that one, Watson was just a matter of a few feet from the hole with his tee shot, while Rogers was in the bunker. However, Watson missed the little putt, and Rogers got up and made a tremendous putt for his par, so nothing changed there. That's about pretty much the story. We could mention other people, of course, who are still hanging on, but why don't we just see them as the play progresses, Jack?
Thank you, Jim. We're looking out across Carmel Bay there. There's the leaderboard at this moment. Watson and Rogers at 4 under, Nicholas Graham and Pohl at 3, Bruce Devlin at 2, George Burns, Jay Haas, and Gary Koch were finished at 1 under, and Calvin Pete playing very steadily at 1 under. Clampett's now gone to even. Now David Graham for a birdie. He's at the 11th hole. And is 3 under par. This would tie him for the lead. Now to Bill Rogers, second shot.
Another very short drive with a pretty long iron into this hole.
He's going left to right with it, Rossi?
Yeah, it's not going to come enough to the right, though. It's in the bunker. Uh-huh. This reminds me a little of 1976 with John Mahaffey driving so short.
Yes.
And having to hit those long irons into the greens. These greens are so small that you just can't keep doing that yet. He's going to have to start letting out a little.
David Graham tapped in for his par. Now we go to Tom Watson here. Second shot at the 10th.
This shot's to the right. Look out.
Down
the hill.
There?
Down the cliff. Going to be in the very, very tall grass down the hill.
Well, go down and get a look at it for us, Rossi. It's the one place you don't want to be. Now we return to Nicholas. Jack one stroke off the lead.
He's hit a beauty, Jack, right in the middle. After the tee shot he hit here yesterday, I'm sure he's happy with that.
Right down the middle.
And welcome to our viewers over in Britain, the BBC viewers, to the US Open live from Pebble Beach. There's the story, Watson and Rogers at 4 under, but the real drama of the day so far has been Jack Nicklaus's round. He dropped a stroke at the first hole, should have birdied the second, and par five, didn't. So he hadn't made the best of starts and then proceeded to have 5 birdies in a row. He's had a couple of small mistakes since then, but so has Watson. He's missed a short putt. Bill Rogers, the British champion, is putting very well, holding on tremendously well. So is this man, Bruce Devlin, the leader for the first 2 days. The defending champion, David Graham, isn't giving up either, although Devlin doesn't look too happy with that. It's a dull day. It's a great day for golf. It's a pleasure to be here watching these great champions. So back to you, Jack.
Thank you, Peter. And that was Bruce Devlin getting it just on there at the par 3 12th. What a week Bruce Devlin has had. He was co-leader after the first round. He led by 2 shots at the 36th hole mark. Tottered a little bit yesterday, but is still in the thick of it now. 3 shots off the lead. And now, Bob Rosberg, have you spotted Tom Watson's ball?
Yes, I have, Jack. It's in the hazard, of course, and not sitting real badly. I would say that he has a better lie than he would have in the rough around the green.
Uh-huh.
The only thing is he can't see where he's going at all. He's going to have to play a blind shot and can't ground his club, of course, and it's going to be a very, very difficult shot. Bill Rogers has a perfect lie. His shot's going to be very, very fast, though, when it hits the green.
Both of them will be hitting their third shots at this par four. Out at the farthest point from the clubhouse. 10th green, almost in the village of Carmel.
Beautiful shot.
Boy, he's playing beautifully today, isn't he? With a nice
rhythm.
Well,
some touch there, Jack.
Oh, isn't that just lovely? David Graham now with the second shot at the 11th hole. David only one shot off the leaders. On the green, and Watson now gets it airborne. And as you can see, just on. How far does he have to hold par here now, Ross?
Well, he's got to make about a 25 foot or somewhere 20, 25 feet, and coming off the fringe and the way he's been putting, you know, you just don't feel you can make one of these. He's missed so many.
Now looking in from our ABC camera in the boat, across the beach and up the cliff. Watson and Rogers, four under, both in a little bit of trouble here. Nicholas Graham and Pohl just waiting for him. Dan Pohl really having himself a week. He third in the PGA last year, lost in a playoff to the Masters this year, and here he is in the middle of the Open. So all of a sudden he's found out how to play in the majors, Dave.
Certainly has, Jack. Nice young man, as I said earlier. Long hitter, too. If he could get in with about 284, you might have an Open champion that we didn't expect to see.
Tom Watson for par. About 22 feet. Jack Nicklaus. Second shot at 13.
This is one of those shots where he doesn't want too much backspin. There's a lot of slope on this green. As you can see, it's pulling away from the hole a little bit there.
Nicklaus at the 13th, just one shot behind the leaders, Watson and Rogers. Watson has just made a marvelous par recovery here at the 10th. And now it's up to Rogers to do the same. He's facing another one of these putts, though, isn't he? How many do you think he has in him, David? He missed the last one.
I don't know how many he's got, but he better have a bunch of them if he's going to keep doing this.
He's been doing it all week, saving par. Two holes in a row now that he has missed, and that will drop him into second place along with Nicholas Graham and Pohl and make our leader at the moment, Tom Watson. How important that putt was for him a moment ago here. Here is Dan Pohl, his third shot on the big, long par 5 14th. Crowd reacting to the bogey of Rogers here at 18. As Pohl gets it just off the back here at 14, which has been a difficult green to hold all week. Now the leader, Tom Watson, never has won the United States Open Championship. And he's as close now as I guess he's ever been. Driving it well the last few holes.
Not only well, but really long. I mean, he's taken the driver out, Jack, almost every hole. He drove at the fourth hole, which you very seldom see anybody do.
Mm-hmm.
He's driven here to just probably a sand wedge in the green.
Bill Rogers.
Oh.
is straight, but again, 30, 35 yards behind Watson.
What could be the reason for that, Rossi?
Well, it looks like he's hitting everything thin to me. He hasn't gotten a ball in the air. He doesn't hit it very high to start with, but he really hasn't hit a ball in the air really well all day. He hasn't hit a real long drive all day.
Look at that group at one under. As we look at David Graham, a defending champion, just one shot off. And that's Dan Pole on the left for a birdie at the 14th. This would tie David for the lead should he be able to sink it. No. And a par for David to keep him at three under, one shot off the lead. Trying to become the first man since Ben Hogan to successfully defend this championship. Now we have Pole over at 14 for par. Dan's at three under. Yes, sir. Stays there. Now Jack Nicklaus at the 13th. Is uphill Ed Snead?
Jack, he's got a pretty good angle to putt. He's putting pretty much uphill, so he'll be in position to give it a good run.
Shy again, huh?
Well, I guess, you know, after you do what you did at the 11th hole, you get a little gun-shy sometimes.
Right. When I say shy again, he was doing that yesterday. Certainly today, when he had his five birdies in a row, he wasn't shy at all.
Well, he made two putts in a row at the third and fourth holes that he hasn't done all week, mm-hmm. And I guess that pumped him up for a while, but he's lost the touch maybe a little bit momentarily.
Come on, Cal.
Still only one shot away, though. Nicklaus is from Tom Watson. And here is Bill Rogers, as you see the surf pounding behind him. This hole 11 goes away from the ocean. Beautifully trapped, this hole. Sits at an angle. What he'll have. Till the last two holes, he had been playing so well, smooth, confidently.
Watson really couldn't be in a better place to play into this hole. He's on the left-hand side of the fairway with a very, very short iron, either a little pitching wedge or a big sandwich. He wants to keep it below the hole if possible. Good-looking shot.
This goes right past Bill Rogers' ball. This is David Graham at the 12th, par 3, downhill.
Jack, David's starting to been playing beautifully today. After his bogey at the 8th hole, he's just hit it right down the middle and long, and he's hit his irons right where he wants them, and he's really starting to play well. He's got that look in his eyes. I think he really knows he's got a chance now.
Just one stroke off the lead.
This ball's to the right, Jack.
Well, he's on the green, just about the same place Nicklaus was a moment ago. There's the championship bays, and we'll be back to Pebble Beach in a moment.
Back again at the U.S. Open, final round. Happy to have not only those of you in the United States with us, but also those of you watching in Great Britain and Ireland and Australia, many places overseas. Bill Rogers with a birdie attempt on the 11th hole, coming off two bogeys in a row. It's steadying time for Rogers, the young man who is the current British Open champion. Give that one a chance. Should he win here, he'll be holding both of those titles at the same time. Rogers of Texarkana. There's your leaderboard. The man on front, Tom Watson, has won just about everything in the game of golf except the PGA Championship and particularly the U.S. Open. He's never won the Open. Also in the running, Jack Nicklaus, trying for an unprecedented fifth U.S. Open championship as Rogers makes the par. And David Graham trying to repeat. No Australian had ever won our title until last year. Now he's trying to win it twice in a row. And Dan Pohl, a young fellow who came out on tour, played so badly at first that he lost his car, earned it back again, and last year finished third in the PGA. This year lost a playoff for the Masters. Just stories everywhere. Bobby Clampett, the hometown boy. On and on. And all on the gorgeous links overlooking the waters from the Pacific coming into Carmel Bay. Water wandering around here, but the leaders are moving to the inland part of the course right now as Watson lines up his birdie attempt. Then they go back to the sea for 17 and 18.
Big putt for Tom at 10, Jim. He hadn't made anything all day, and then to save that par after a bad second shot. Now if he could make this, give him a little breathing room.
Made a heroic par at 10. At 11. Tom Watson has seized a two-shot lead in the U.S. Open.
It would be a very popular victory if that young man won, because it means so much to him and to his career to win the Open. He said that, stated it. He's had a couple of chances, hasn't won. Sometimes you wonder, well, will it be like Sam Snead and not win one? We'll take another look at Tom's putt here. Once he gets rolling, Jim, he might just make everyone from here in.
Mm-hmm.
He has a beautiful stroke and he's a lot of courage.
So the long, long putt at 10 for a par, the long putt at 11 for a birdie. Watson now one under for the day, five under for the championship, but most important, two strokes in front. The holes aren't running out yet, but they will be soon. The defending champion, Graham, putting for a birdie. He must have heard that yell just behind him. He knows that either Rogers or Watson have done something.
He knows one of them did. The crowd here just got the word that Watson birdied.
Yep. Graham, putting beautifully. That one left for the par. Look of concentration. Man who was so moved and touched by winning the Open Championship last year. Now, let's see. We have Jack Nicklaus with a problem. Frank Hannigan, any ideas on what this might be?
No, I see Arthur Rice, the referee, is... Yeah, it's through a divot. If the divot has been replaced, he can't move it. It's not a loose impediment. He's got to play it.
Well, he's going to play it. Jack Nicklaus now two shots out of the lead. Second shot on the long par 5, 14th hole, 565 yards long. Dogleg to the right. Not from this point, he's already past the corner of the dogleg.
Jim, he's hit a perfect second shot. The ball divot behind his ball was actually about 8 or 10 inches behind his ball, and I don't think it really affected the shot too much.
Okay, that was Ed Snead walking with the Nicklaus pair there. So Jack will have a third shot up to that green. There's his ball, as Ed said, in very nice shape. Son Jack walking along with his father. A little bit of conversation. Companions on the golf course on Father's Day. Ben Crenshaw on 18. Everybody wants to win a major championship, but nobody wants one more than Ben does, let's say. Ben Crenshaw started the day two over. He's now three over. In other words, one over on today's round. No U.S. Open championship for him again this year.
Just can't seem to drive well enough, Jim. You have to keep the ball in the fairway at major tournaments or you're in lots of trouble.
David Graham for the par. All right, he stays at 3 under in a tie with Nicklaus, Rogers, and Dan Pohl, 2 shots behind leader Watson. Now Crenshaw.
It's 4 birdie.
Birdie 4 here would give him an even par round of 72 today. Going nicely, just below. So the par 5 should give him a round of 73 today. Ben Crenshaw with earlier rounds of 76, 74, and 68 yesterday. Watson on the par 3 hole. 204 yards long. Well, just when all goes well for anybody in this championship, something seems to occur. I think he's found the bunker there, Ben. Yep, there it is, in the bunker.
You have to prefer that bunker to the tall grass around the green, so he's a good bunker player and obviously a good putter.
Well, remember 10 years ago when Nicklaus won here, on the last day, he put it over the green in that long grass, then hit it about 3 feet, if you remember, then put it 10 feet past, and then, of course, made the 10-footer for a bogey. Bill Rogers. Crenshaw made his 5 at 18 for a round of 73. So the tee pop up in the air.
Beautiful shot, right at it.
A little long though, just on the back edge. Bill Rogers not too happy with it. I'd like to remind you that the 1982 U.S. Open is being brought to you by Goodyear, for more Goodyears in your car. By the Bell System, applying knowledge to the needs of business. By Staff Clubs from Wilson, you can play what the pros play. And by De Beers, the name that stands for diamond, the perfect gift for any occasion. A diamond is forever. Nicklaus, third shot on 14.
Even though it's not a long shot, Jim, a very difficult shot here to get close to the hole. That flag is not too far over the bunker. Difficult to judge just how hard to hit it.
Should he make a birdie here and Watson make a bogey, we could have the two-shot swing again. And they'd be tied.
As I said, very difficult to get close. And of course, if one man you'd have to pick, it's him.
Okay, we'll be following them right along from now, but right now we're going to have a message from the USGA. Back at Pebble, Tom Watson still with a two-stroke lead, but it may not last too long the way things are going at the moment. On the par 3 12th hole, he is in the bunker with his tee shot. Jack Nicklaus has a chance at a birdie up ahead of him. As you look at the leaderboard, both pages of it. Okay, now Tom with the shot. Nice flat lie, pretty much, looks like, as he comes out. And leaves himself that one. Well, he's made ones that long or longer on the last two holes, but you can't do it forever. At least nobody has up to here. You notice that he went to Stanford University, and his victory, although popular everywhere in the country, would be particularly so here. Stanford, just a couple hours up the road from here at Palo Alto. And a lot of people cheering for Tom. Dan Pohl led the PGA Tour in driving last year with an average of 280.1 yards.
I don't think he likes that. I couldn't tell for sure.
Oh, there it is, just off the
back
putting
left.
Surface. Yeah. What is he this year, about second or third, isn't
he's
he,
second
driving?
270.
Slipping, eh? 27-year-old Dan Pohl from Mount Pleasant, Michigan. Rogers. A shot behind Watson, tied with Nicklaus and David Graham and Dan Pohl.
very fast going that way, Jim. Mm-hmm. That's why I was surprised that Watson's shot stopped fairly quickly down the hill.
I suspect Tom was, too. Now, David Graham hitting out of the rough. John Schroeder, is that a particularly difficult one?
No, Jim, he got a good break. He got past, just past a big clump of bad rough. He's got a relatively good line. He's got a great angle up the flag. If he carries a shot right on the front edge, the ball should run right up to the hole.
Well, let's see.
He's got a little right, Jim.
Yes, he has.
Oh, that is absolutely
long stuff.
That is very deep there. I've seen a number of players, and that's what you have to do if you're going to try to get close, is stay up to the right there, but it is jungle.
I'm sure John will go up and try to get a really close look at it. Now Watson for the par that he needs to hold on to this lead, or else we'll have a five-way tie. Excuse me, two. He'll hold on to the lead, but he loses one. Excuse me. Anticipating a possible couple of birdies. No, he still leads by one stroke. But the bulge has disappeared. And now, should Jack Nicklaus make this putt, we will in fact have a tie for the lead. Something coming back. Nicklaus at 3 under for the championship, 2 under for the day. And again, if you've just joined us, he had 5 birdies in a row. Look at lots of vantage points here at Pebble Beach.
I wonder how the people that own the homes like them up in those trees, though.
Yeah. Now Jack looking at the putt he needs for a par. Excuse me. As Phil Rogers looks at his also. Jack looking over his up ahead as Rogers looks here on 12. Oh, he jabbed that one.
He's pushed it. He's missed three out of the last 4 holes. He's missed makeable, very makeable putts, 4 feet, 5 feet. Hit a real good shot in there, back fringed, put it by, and missed that one. Come on, Bill, hold your head up. We got a lot of golf left.
Drops down to 2 under. He's now 2 over par on today's round is Bill Rogers. The British Open champion trudges on. 2 shots behind the man with whom he is playing. So Watson now with a single stroke lead over David Graham and Dan Pohl and Nicklaus, if Nicklaus makes his par putt on the 14th hole. It's all going to be decided, if it is decided today, on those closing holes. No question of that now. If there should be a playoff, it will be at 18 holes tomorrow. There is no sudden death in the United States Open. All right. Remains a stroke off the lead. We should tell you, by the way, can tell you, that Nathaniel Crosby has become the low amateur in this year's United States Open and will receive a gold medal. He won by 1 stroke over the only other amateur in it, Corey Pavin. Tom Watson driving on 13. It was a very nice scene, Dave, when he came in. Corey Pavin was watching from off the 18th green. As soon as Nathaniel made the putt to beat him, Pavin went out, shook his opponent's hand, put his arm around him, and they walked off together. David Graham with as tough a shot as you'll find that close to a flag stick.
He doesn't have a good lie. He'll be fortunate to keep it within 10 feet of the hole, Jim.
As far as he was able to move it. So David Graham in trouble. Tom Watson with a single stroke lead over him and Jack Nicklaus. More to come.
Welcome back to this year's Open Championship from Pebble Beach. The leaderboard, and it's ever changing. Watson leads by 1, Nicholas, well, he's there as usual. David Graham, still three under, but about to lose a stroke. Of that, we're convinced. All these other players very close by. David Graham at the 15th. This was his... this is the 13th. He was short in the grass. Played one. This is his fourth shot. Look at that swing by the hole, and it's still going. Just misjudged his second shot a little bit, and now Graham struggling. So it's almost back to the old firm of Nicholas and Watson. Nicholas, tee shot, 15.
It's a 3-wood, Peter, down the left side of the fairway.
Will it stay? Yes, it will. Nicholas, just those couple of holes ahead of Watson, and if he can finish well, he'll set a very tough target. Now, this is for a bogey for David Graham. And he's not got it. So the comparatively easy-looking 13th hole costs defending champion Graham a six. Double bogey six. Puts him back to just one under. What a costly hole. Unlucky 13. Well, there's still much to play for here, and, well, the greatest names in golf battling away at the top of that leaderboard. Here's Nicholas looking down to this 15th green. Nicholas just one stroke behind Watson. Rogers has missed three shortish putts in a row. He's now just two under, and Pole up ahead has dropped a stroke. So it's down to one of those classic duels again, or so it would appear, Nicholas and Watson.
He's got a 9-iron here, and to get close to the pin, I think he needs to draw the ball a little bit. The pin's on the left side of the green.
Get in there, ball.
Just to the right of the pin.
Oh, another fine shot. He had a very holeable putt for birdie on the long par 5. 13th hole, which he just missed. He needs to get one in, I feel, if he's going to win this championship. 13th fairway. Just look at the size of that bunker up the left-hand side of the fairway. The hole goes slightly uphill. There's Bill Rogers. Been struggling over the last three or four holes. Not hitting the ball very crisply.
Another comparatively long shot, Peter. Again, Watson put it 40 yards past him.
Oh, Rogers unlucky. Looks like he just got the right pitch and bounce, but it stopped. That could have gone very close to the hole. Remember, David Graham, not too long ago, took six on this hole. Rogers, though, on the green, but driving a very short distance. Watson driving magnificently, Frank.
Extraordinary. He's driven it at every fairway today.
Watson, second of the 13th, championship leader, and good shot. Dan Pole, 17th tee. Oh, when he lets go of the club, that looked to be a bit of an edgy one. And there it is, short, and finds the bunker in front of the green.
Playing the back tee today, Peter, 210 yards. Colossal hole today.
Harry Rinker, who figured so prominently in the early rounds, just finishing up on the 18th and just over Burrows. He's going to have a very good championship, though. He's two over for the championship, and he'll remember this for a long time, and was might be just on the borderline for getting an invitation next year, Frank, or do you think he'll be perhaps one too many? What is it, the leading 15?
It's the leading 15 for the Open Championship, yes.
They're invited back next year without having to qualify.
Exactly.
Well, remember the name, Young Brinkler. He may well be star of the future. Look at that pin, how near it is to the front of this green. And he's done it. Well done. 74 and a championship total of 2 over par. 290. Not bad going at all. Two amateurs made the cut, and Nathaniel Crosby, who is the amateur champion of the United States, just sneaked in ahead of Corey Faben by one stroke, 303 to 304. So young Master Crosby is the leading amateur in this year's Open. Very good playing indeed. When you think of the great names that didn't qualify for the final two rounds, those two young amateurs should be very proud of their efforts. So, still there, Watson, just ahead of Nicklaus. Rogers having stumbled over the last few holes. Now Watson, there are three at the 13th. Well, he's holed a couple of long putts. He missed a tiny one, not much more than 2.5 feet at the 7th for a birdie 2. Had a bit of an up and down round with his putter, but he's driven the ball, as Frank Hannigan was saying, quite majestically. Still in the lead by one with holes running out. But what holes left to play? Everyone a gem, everyone a potential disaster. Well, we said at the start of the program, you'll see over 4 hours their whole, perhaps their character changing, their life changing, as they battle their way around this course. And that's how it is. Nicklaus and Watson. And here he is. Nicklaus for a birdie at the 15th.
It's a very makeable putt, Peter.
Bill Rogers on the right for a birdie at the 13th. He's done it. Nicklaus does it. What a time, what a man. What an incredible character he is, to be sure. And he's two holes ahead of Watson, which may make a tremendous difference over the final stages. And he actually looks just as enjoying himself. And son there with him on this Father's Day. I'll just take a moment to wish my daughter Carol a happy birthday today on Father's Day. 22 today. Not too many fizzy drinks, and remember your father's advice.
The sense of continuity of the game is marvelous, isn't it? Nicklaus and Watson at Turnberry, at Augusta, now at Pebble Beach.
Yeah, the game is such an extraordinary game, and it does breed some remarkable characters. Now, Rogers, can he hold this for his par 4? And he's got one in. Missed two or three of those, perhaps a little bit longer. The pole dropped a stroke at the 17th, so he's gone just to one under with the 18th left to play. Nicklaus back to the 16th tee. Level. Mm-hmm.
Peter, as Jack was walking to the 15th green, he was talking with his son, and they were looking at the scoreboard, and they just put up a couple of scores, I believe, where Graham had taken double bogey, and another score where someone had lost a shot. And he said something to Jackie, I couldn't quite overhear it, but I think he could see that the other players are having a little bit of trouble, and I think it might have sparked him a little bit.
This is a fine hole, isn't it? This 16th hole. There's Watson just a couple of holes behind, just sizing up his tee shot. Nicklaus here at the 16th. New bunker down the right-hand side, Frank, for the championship. Small bunker to catch a wayward tee shot.
Yeah, it makes the tee shot a good, something that pinches it in. Yeah, can't afford to miss it right.
looks like a three wood. Just three holes to go. Anxious. No need to be, Jack. Just to the corner, and there's the green. Just perched on the very front of the putting surface.
The hole cut very near the front of the green, only 20 feet.
Well, just three holes to go in this final round of the Open, and it's Nicklaus and Watson tied for the lead. Couldn't get better than that.
There they are, ladies and gentlemen, golfing history in the 70s and 80s. Jack Nicklaus on the right, Tom Watson on the left. Once again, locked. And as struggle for the championship of the United States as they were in Great Britain at Turnberry in 77, as they've been at the Masters. Nicklaus at 16, Tom Watson at 14. Both at four under par, two strokes ahead of everybody else. Up here on the 18th green, this is the local boy, Bobby Clampett. And to show you how close this competition is, he almost chipped it in for an eagle, which would have made him the leader at three under of those who had finished. This is for birdie. Marvelous tournament for this young man. And wait till you hear the roar that goes up. Hometown boy from Carmel, California. Clampett finishes this tournament at two under par. They're taking dead aim at the 18th. Spatter and Clampett almost got on in two. They were just short of the neck. And now Dan Pole, I believe, has just put it on here in two, about 40 feet away, as you look at the crowd around the last hole. And as Jim McKay said, this championship is going to be decided on these closing holes as we look at Bill Rogers, who has staggered just a bit over the last four holes. He has dropped now to two under. There's the current leaderboard. So David Graham and Rogers temporarily fallen out of this close competition. Dan Pole had trouble at the 17th. Trouble at the 16th. Here's Rogers' second shot at this par 5, 14th hole.
Just perfect. We have a very interesting situation here, Jack. Watson is where he can definitely put it on the green. Now it's a matter of whether you want to take a shot at it or not. George Burns just knocked it on from behind where Tom is right now. So he's going to take an iron, though.
Okay. As we look at Nicklaus looking down here at 16, second shot.
He's got a nine iron, Jack. Perfect position off the tee.
Doesn't like something, though, huh?
Well, sometimes when you step up to a shot like that, you just don't feel like you're properly aligned, and many times a player will go ahead and swing and a bad shot results. Mm-hmm. But a player like Nicklaus doesn't make that mistake very often. I guess there's only one player like Nicklaus. Mm-hmm.
Well, that looks to be about what, 12 feet?
That's what it looks like to me, Jack. I'm standing out down the fairway a ways, but it looks like he's got a very good putt at another birdie.
He's walking at that pace, too. Look at him. Now, when that was going on, this was Watson back at 14. And that's what he has left for his third shot here at this par five. Watson and Nicklaus tied at the moment, four under. Here at the 18th, Lanny Watkins now, who is at even par. His third shot. coming out of that rough, it's hard to stop the ball.
That's absolutely as good as he could do from there, Jack.
Absolutely. That's some of the heaviest rough on the course, I think, over there. His playing partner, Dan Pohl, has put it on in two as we go back to Nicklaus up at the 16th. Nicklaus and Watson. Watson and Nicklaus. What a road show. What a show for us. There's Bruce Devlin still in red figures through 15. And there's the money situation. But much more at stake in this championship. There's Paul here for Eagle. Put him back at 3 under and give him the lead. Great tournament for this young man, though. He faltered at bogeys at 16 and 17, almost got them back here. He makes this little time with Bobby Clampett at 2 under. Grandstand around the 18th green. Yes, sir. Dan Pohl with a birdie here at the home hole goes to 2 under. He and Clampett finishing their rounds. The 1982 United States Open at 2 under par. To give him an awful lot of confidence, Dave, for the tour.
He's played well in some major championships this year, and he's had some shoulder problems, yeah. Jack, but I guess he's back healthy again. You can't play that well.
Now let's find out how Tom Watson will handle his third shot at the 14th. Rossi?
Jack, he's really a little unlucky. He does not have a good lie. Very, very cuppy kind of lie. I'm surprised if he's very surprised if he shoots it at the flag.
Well, he pushed it right through the green, right onto the back edge. Now Rogers' third shot. Not very nicely for Bill Rogers.
And a little bit unlucky, Jack, because that's very firm in that part. You would think the ball might take a good hop toward the hole.
Yeah. Now we're at the 16th green. Nicklaus with a birdie putt. Say 12, 15 feet.
That's what it looks like, Jack.
Mm-hmm. Nicklaus and Watson tied for the lead. I don't know who wrote the script, Frank Hannigan, but it's pretty good. At 16 for one of the co-leaders. Jack Nicklaus going for a fifth U.S. Open win. Tom Watson going for his first. Now back to the ocean and memories of 1972 for Nicklaus. Look at the crowd coming down from 16 now to the 17th tee, which is across the road today. Now we go back to the 14th and Tom Watson. The back fringe.
He's got to be careful here, Jack. That is very swift going that way.
Look at that spike. Goodness, what a putt.
That's being careful.
Oh, memories of Turnberry again. Young Mr. Watson.
goes to the lead by himself, 5 under par. Oh my, what a remarkable putt. As the roar goes up here at 18 as they see it on the board. Just as he did at Turnberry in a late holes, rolling it in from the fringe. What would you think this distance is? 40 feet, 35 anyway, David.
35 to 40, just as you said. And great touch here because that is really fast going down there. You remember Nicklaus's putt from about 8 feet, knocked it 2 feet by. Look at here.
Wow. Well, the putter is going to get Tom there. The putt at 10 to hold par, and that one, magnificent. The leader.
That's how it stands at this moment. Nicklaus makes his way to the tee at 17. And wouldn't he like to have the one iron shot that he had in 72?
Ooh.
And he needs it now.
He sure
doesn't
does.
Have the lead this time. What Watson's putt may have done to Bill Rogers here. It looks like Bill's thinking, well, maybe I can birdie this and pick up a stroke on Tom. Mm-hmm. Now he's got to make it just to stay three back. Pushed it out.
Par for Bill Rogers. He stays at 2 under. Let's go quickly now to Jim McKay.
Well, once again, if you've just joined us by any chance, the big dramatic move of this day took place when Jack Nicklaus birdied 5 holes in a row on the front nine. That's what got him into it, put him into contention, and now the head-to-head mano-a-mano struggle with Tom Watson. Think of it, Nicklaus won the U.S. Open 20 years ago, 15 years ago, 10 years ago, and 2 years ago. Tom Watson has never won it. He's won 3 British Opens, he's won the Masters, but he's never won this one, the one he wants to win most of all. Okay, Jack.
17th tee, where he hit the memorable shot 10 years ago that hit the pin.
Great shot.
Well,
he's done it again.
Not quite as dramatic as 72, Ed Snead, but he's on nicely, isn't he? About 10 feet away at the 17th. He's one stroke behind Tom Watson, who leads this championship at this moment.
Now it's once more to the sea, men. Once more to the waters of Carmel Bay to fight it out for the U.S. Open Golf Championship. Jack Nicklaus on 17. Behind him, the leader now, Tom Watson, coming off a birdie to snatch the lead again by a single stroke. Bobby Clampett finished a 2-under. Bill Rogers still with Watson, not quite out of it, but fading fast. David Graham at 1-under, the defending champion. If you're wondering what happened to people like Bruce Devlin today, he's at 1-under through 15. Cal Pete hanging very nicely, playing with Nicklaus at 1-under. There's George Burns slipping back. Others who have all completed their rounds. Ben Crenshaw down at the bottom of the board. Larry Nelson, the PGA champion. Hal Sutton, former U.S. amateur champion there. Craig Stadler, the Masters champion. Andy North, the former U.S. Open champion. Tom Kite did not have a good closing round. Isao Aoki had 71 today, 1 under par. He had a tough weekend. Jim Thorpe finished up with an eagle on the 18th hole. That's plus 6, and that the fact that he made an eagle, of course, was due to the fact he was able to get on in 2, and a number of people have done that so far today that could come into play on this final hole when Nicklaus and Watson come along. Ray Floyd, too late for him. And now, to the play. Two particularly proud dads are going to fight it out on Father's Day. Jack Nicklaus, the father of 5, one of whom is caddying for him, his son Jack. Tom Watson here, father of a little girl and another child on the way. This is on tape now of Tom Watson's tee shot on the 15th. Par 4, it used to be through a sort of funnel of trees, but they cut them back a little bit.
Not a whole lot though, Jim, let me tell you. Tom's had the best rhythm today swinging that I've seen in a long time. He's usually very quick anyhow.
Sometimes gets a little quick, doesn't it?
But it is very good today.
Now we're back again live. This is
Jim McKay with Dave Barr behind 18, where we've been joined again as spectators by former President Gerald Ford, who only loves the game about as much as Nicholas and Watson. I think,
and you.
And me.
Doesn't play quite as well.
He said he doesn't play quite as well. Plays well enough. Phil Rogers, three behind. It's going to be tough.
One of the few players on tour that plays without a glove.
Go in the hole. That's
going,
what.
Well, he needs to go in the hole.
That's what he needs, and it was
May.
It was, in fact, right at that stick, wasn't it? Isn't that the kind of determination, the kind of belief that makes champions?
When you play well, you can perform miracles. We get the opportunity to sit up here and watch them, and I just am amazed at how well they play, how much courage these players have. Putt to Tom made on the last hole.
David, he's down here with just a little wedge to the green. This is the longest I've ever seen Tom. I've seen him play an awful lot, but never hit it this long.
There he is, safely on the 15th. One more birdie would make it awfully difficult for Nicholas, but he may have ideas of his own. He usually does. You know, it just occurred to me when I was out there doing that report that he did win it 20 years ago in a playoff with Arnold Palmer. 15 years ago, again, Palmer was second at Baldersroll. 10 years ago, here at Pebble Beach, and of course, 2 years ago at Baldersroll again.
He has dominated the game for 20 years, Jack. Jack has.
His putting grip.
That putter has killed many a player, too.
This to tie for the lead.
Hit it.
Quite. There have been, by the way, 26 playoffs in the U.S. Open, the last one. We remember 1975, Lou Gramm winning over John Mahaffey at Medina. Again, if you've just joined us, should there be a playoff, it's 18 holes tomorrow. And we'll be there. One more hole for Jack Nicklaus. Only one more chance to do any good for himself. But we will repeat, 18 has been very birdieable on this final day. And there have been a couple of eagles. Tomorrow night, Monday Night Baseball, Detroit at Boston. They battle in... battling it out for first place in the American League, or Philadelphia. Philly's coming back a little bit, chasing St. Louis, first place in their division, 8:30 Eastern, 7:30 Central.
Beat decision time for Nicklaus at 18. How hard do you try to hit it? Does he realize that you can reach the green today? I'm sure he does. Just how much do you try to cut off and go over the ocean? Or do you just trust that you could play it down there in two shots and knock a wedge on and make a putt? He knows where he is.
We saw that Dan Pohl got home in two. We saw Jim Thorpe get home in two. Craig Stadler got home in two. And a couple of others. But as you say, Jack, no doubt does not have that knowledge at the moment.
Wonder what they're thinking about.
So fascinating. Only our medium can put them literally head to head. Several holes apart. Battling it out.
Look back at the three putt that Nicklaus had at 11, short putt that Tom missed at 7. Of course, they've made some, but those are the things that you wake up in a cold sweat with some night.
Could be the critical putt.
Hold on. Don't get too aggressive, Thomas.
Going for the hole, but he always does. One of not too many, it seems to me, touring professionals who almost always leaves the flag stick in when he's hitting from just off the green, because he is almost always past the hole, and Tom figures that gives him a little chance to hit the stick and drop.
His aggressiveness is a lot like Arnold. Mm-hmm. Very rarely, when Arnold was in his prime, did he leave any putt short. I mean, he bent a lot of pins that he left in. Mm-hmm.
Doing the numbers game again. I guess you pointed out yesterday that Nicklaus is 42, Watson is 32, Palmer 52,
Clampett is 22.
Well, let's have a look at the 18th along the seawall, down towards the tree that can prove a barrier in the middle of the fairway there, on the right-hand side of the middle of the fairway. and then down to the tee, where Jack Nicklaus makes the attempt to become the first man ever to win five U.S. Open golf championships, to surpass the record of Willie Anderson and Bobby Jones and Ben Hogan and himself. After this one, he would just about have only himself to surpass. 20th major championship would be as a windsurfer goes behind him. Ed Snead?
I haven't been able to pick the ball up yet left. Yet. Yep. It's right in the middle of the fairway.
Yep, out. Three wood he hit, out past the second tree, so he may be playing it a bit conservatively. Bill Rogers.
Left.
He really had to have that one. But Nicklaus will be playing 18 when we return to the U.S. Open at Pebble Beach.
Welcome back to the closing stages of this year's United States Open Championship. Tom Watson, one ahead after 15 holes. Jack Nicklaus striding his way up the final hole. Or will it be the final hole? We've yet to see. David Graham, the defending champion, still out on the course. A lot of players have already completed their rounds. And what a day it's been. I keep thinking that I've seen it all. It can't be as exciting this year as it was last year or in 1977 or whenever. And yet, the excitement seems to grow. Defending champion here, David Graham. Second shot to the 16th green. One over for the day, one under for the championship. Second shot to this flag, which is very close to the edge of the green. Not much room to pitch. Oh, very good. Look at that ball. Jump and spin. Gives him a putt for a three. Nicklaus, who took a three wood from the 18th tee. There's a plan of this 18th hole. He took a three wood. He's gone past the two trees on the right of the fairway. This green has been reached today by two or three players. Nicklaus, though, playing it conservatively, relying on a pitch and a putt, taking an iron, playing up to the corner there, and then the flag, as you can see, well to the front of this green.
Peter, when Jack got ready to hit his tee shot, it appeared to me that the wind was against him off the tee, so he probably thought there was no chance he could get home in two, and I'm sure that's the reason he chose the three wood.
Thank you, Ed. Oh, no, Nicklaus just advancing it up the fairway.
It's right in the middle.
There it is. Almost like a game of chess, plotting his way carefully, but he's quite a long way back, and the flag, you can see, only seven yards on this green. Not a lot of room.
I'm sure he wants to leave a shot that he can hit hard enough to put spin on the ball.
16th tee, here's Bill Rogers. Just tee shot safely away. Right down the course now. Watson had the honor, and this is what he did. He's been driving beautifully all day long. This was recorded. He had the honor. This was his tee shot at the 16th. Left it down the right-hand side, and into trouble. Now, Bob, how's that one sitting up?
That one is dead. That's in that new bunker, Peter. He has no chance at all. I don't say ain't no chance because I've been wrong so many times, but I think he'll just have to take a sand wedge and explode the ball out to the fairway. He's right up against the bank. He's only a foot and a half from the bank, and there's no way that he can get the ball to green.
Well, what a time to miss the fairway with your first tee shot. There's Watson's ball, and there's the bank that Bob was describing right in front, and it would be a very brave man, or a foolish one, to try and attempt to fly it onto the green. Now, here's a diagram of Watson's tee shot. You can see he left it down the right-hand side, a new bunker down on that right-hand side, which was placed there, not specifically for Tom, but he's in it. He's a stroke ahead. Watson, two behind this man, two holes behind this man, who's up the 18th. Taking the applause of the crowd, already many deep round this final hole, and what wouldn't Jack give for a birdie four here? It's one of the fascinations about golf. So many things can happen. Players can suddenly finish with two or three birdies. Someone seemingly in the driving seat can let it all slip away. It's Cal Pete. Even par. He's had pars at almost every hole. Couple of bogeys, one birdie, but a very consistent straight hitter. Not the greatest of putters, but my word, how straight he hits. And he's right on target. Really not a lot of room. That was a beautiful shot. But still, he's 14 or 15 feet past the hole. Now, Nicklaus. Must get this one as close as he can. Not a lot of room to pitch. The tree there doesn't really block his view to the pin. So easy to try and get it near and just miss hit it under club. Trouble everywhere.
The wind should help him on the shot.
Come down, they cried.
And it'll spin.
The reason it should come back. Look at this. Not too bad. Nicklaus, who had that remarkable run of five birdies early on in his round from the third hole, had a couple of missed chances since then. And here he is once again, after being at the top of the tree for more than 20 years, coming to the final hole, and the great applause of the mass crowds, one of the giants in the world of sport. They rise to him, and the game. Nice to see a smile, isn't it, in this hard, cruel world of what they call professionalism. This man, one of the greatest professionals of them all. Very emotional scenes. Now to the relative peace of the 16th. Roger's second. Get up, and it did. Fine shot. Fine shot. Well, Bob, how's it looking now for Watson?
I believe he's just coming out to the left. He just can't afford to take a chance.
Yes, indeed. Just flips it out sideways into the middle of the fairway where his tee shot.
And I tell you, this is not going to be too good, Peter, because the ball's on the downslope. He really couldn't advance it forward enough to get it to the flat. Now he has a very, very little pitch off a downhill line where the pin is. It's almost impossible to put enough spin on it to stop it.
Well, this man doesn't know what's going on back there at the 16th. All he'll be interested in and concentrating on is the job in hand, a putt on this 18th hole. But first, it's Cal Pete. Nicklaus will be stalking around, looking at the board, getting the feel of it, thinking how he's left a couple of putts short. he'll get a look at this man's putt, get some idea of the roll and the speed. Pete, two putts for a championship total of 288, level par. Over borrowed it. Let it go whizzing by. No, he's going to wait. Or is he going to wait? No?
No, Jack asked him if he wanted to hole out.
16th fairway, Watson's third. Off the downslope. Not much green to land on. Well, it's way to the back of the green. Safely on, but a long way from the hole. And is his moment slipping away? Well, early days yet. Pete, though, at the 18th. This for par 5. And an even par total of 288. Yes, well done. Good championship. 73 today, 288, Calvin Pete. Well, what a setting. What a moment. Now, Watson behind at the 16th, having played three shots but a stroke ahead. Nicklaus here at the 18th with a putt for a birdie. If Jack could hold this, they would both be five under. But Watson back at the 16th, odds on to drop a stroke. So if Jack could hold this putt, he could jump into the lead. If he two putts and Watson misses, they'll be level, and then Watson would have to par the last two holes for there to be a playoff. So many permutations still left. Now, Jack's had a few of these over the last five or six holes. He three-putted from about this distance at the 11th. He's left a couple dead on line short. It's his favorite arena, the 18th green. With a putt that could be the one. He's gone four and a half feet past. And this is no gimme. I remember Orville Moody three-putting this green, having problems. Now, Watson at the 16th. Fourth shot. Oh, look at this. What a marvelous putt. It's a stroke dropped. Just missed the fairway by a few yards, cost him a stroke. Goes back to four under. Nicklaus at the 18th with this putt to remain four under. Look at that. Nerves of steel, this man. Right into the center of the hole. He finishes at four under, just as if he was playing a little Sunday afternoon four ball. For who buys the drinks? What a man, and what a target he set. Watson, who's still got a couple of holes to play.
I don't know if Jack realizes yet that Watson has bogeyed 16.
I doubt it now that it's just going up on the board, and Jack had a quick look up, and he's looking again and thinking, hello, hello. Tom has to get a 3 and a 5 to tie, or indeed a 3 and a 4 to win. Bill Rogers, of course, could finish. That's what he's looking up at. But we shouldn't forget this man. He could finish with 3 birdies and sneak it from under everyone's nose. But first, you've got to hold that one. He was almost on the move there before he hit it. But you could see how fast that putt was. Now, Watson is collecting his thoughts. The scoring system here has been excellent. Scores have flashed up around the course very quickly indeed. And it won't be too long before Watson knows the exact position, and he's got that very formidable 17th tee shot. Of
wow, he's got to make that swing on the 17th hole.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Well, now, Rogers, having had a short putt for a birdie, this for a par. This to remain 2 under. It's there, and just 2 holes to go. Can Watson do it? Will it be Nicklaus's turn?
It's high sporting drama on the shores of Carmel Bay. A man from Columbus, Ohio, and a man from Kansas City battling it out for the United States Open Golf Championship. Jack Nicklaus, 4 times winner of the title, going for an unprecedented 5th. Tom Watson, the game's greatest star for the past 5 years, going for his 1st. It's eluded him every single time up to here. Bill Rogers, still on the course, 2 shots behind. A miracle finish could put him back in it. They're on the 17th hole. It's 210 yards long, hitting towards the sea. Using a wood, he has been so short today.
But he's a very fine 4-wood player, and he's probably going to play a left to right in there.
Long hourglass-shaped green, and he's on it safely.
Just shows you, take the club that you can get there the easiest with. Just because everyone else has been hitting an iron, you don't have to be macho man up on the tee. Take the, he's a marvelous 4-wood player too, Billy is.
For Watson, simple the situation to figure out. 2 pars and you tie. A par and a birdie, you win. A par and a bogey, you lose. A 2-iron, we're told. 210 yards again.
Yep.
Sits down. And he's over. Into the deep stuff. Gonna be tough to hold it close from there, isn't it, Dave?
Jim, it looks from here. Again, we can just see the ball very clearly there, but he just doesn't have any green. He's downhill. But he's got a wonderful touch. He's a good up and down player. I think he meant more the down because it was going left, not because it was too long. At first, I thought maybe he was so pumped up, but he hit it too far.
Well, there is the 17th. You see the entire hole there with the gallery streaming around, up waiting for him on 18. Oh, many thousands of people. All the ones who have been out on the course now getting ready to gather. There they are. And they're watching at this moment Bruce Devlin, who's had such a fine championship. Bruce, who in the recent years has done a lot more talking about golf on television for NBC, I might add, than he has playing of the game. Literally, that's actually true. 10 years since he won a tournament. But right now he is at even par for the championship, 2 over for today. This to remain so. And he's got it. Bruce Devlin. Final round of 74 after rounds of 70, 69, and 75. Finishes at even par. Well done.
Great tournament, Bruce.
Now let's go down to Jack Whitaker. He's with Jack Nicklaus.
They're just finishing.
I think we have a little audio problem down there with
problem
Jack and
here,
Jack. So
all right, we have our audio back now, Jack. You're going to have about 15-minute nervous wait here. Are you exhausted?
Well, I'm not exhausted yet. I may have another day to go, Jack.
Well, you had a tremendous round. You know, you make it awful tough on broadcasters and writers. We have no more adjectives left.
Well, I made it awful tough on myself on that last putt.
Oh, what a putt that was, too.
Oh, it was a good putt. But the first putt, I left the putts at 16 and 17 short. And I felt like, I really needed to make a putt to win. I just felt like I felt like I had the line, and I just hit it too hard and hit it right through the break. But and then left myself with that. Oh.
Yes.
Don't want to leave myself too many of those. I've missed too many on this green.
Well, Jack, we're going to wait here with you, and you're on the edge of your fifth open. It's a pleasure to be in your time, I'll tell you.
Thank you, Jack.
Back to Jim McKay.
There's Watson. Jack Nicklaus, who had rounds in this championship of 74, 70, 71, and today 69. He brought it down every single round. As for Watson, he opened with 72, had another 72 on Friday, 68 yesterday. That put him into the midst of the battle. And today, well, today he is even par. The best he's been has been one under today. He's never been worse than even. So it's been basically a very consistent round for him, although he had to make some fine putts to keep it that way.
Well, at first he started out missing a lot of makeable putts, then he made a couple of long ones and got started again. And the drive at 16, which is just a little bit to the right. You look at some scores of the other players that by and large are finished. David Graham's playing 18 now.
We're talking about Father's Day. Of course, a man who is not Tom Watson's father. Tom's very proud of his own dad. But has been very much of a father figure in golf to him is Byron Nelson. I'm sure Byron's watching right now.
He will be as proud as any father could be.
Bill Rogers for a birdie on 17.
Still with a chance.
That's
right. If he
can
get this in and get to three under, he can. 18 is certainly a birdie hole.
Just can't get it going anymore. Rogers started the day four under, now two under, so he's two over on today's round. And now comes, well, possibly the decisive shot of this championship. You can say that any one shot is. If he can get it close and get it down, then he needs only par on the final hole for tie, birdie to win. But
this is a shot of his that he generally plays very well. Of course, the conditions now that he has to play the shot test anyone, so we'll just have to see. Looks
gently
good.
Done.
Looks good. Do you believe it? Do you believe
what
it?
What can you say? Tom Watson pitching into the hole for a birdie has taken the lead in the U.S. Open. One more par, and he's finally won it. We said high drama on the shores of Carmel Bay, and that's what it's turned out to be.
Well, the crowd.
And now the roar from the crowd at 18 as it's posted on the board. Nicklaus watching. Nicklaus watching our coverage on a monitor. Now knows that he can't do a thing. A man like Jack Nicklaus doesn't like to stand there helpless. Tom Watson almost disbelieving.
What it would mean to him to win. He's just wanted it so much. Of course, this man has won four times. Maybe that's the limit they're going to let you win it, all right?
Have here it is again. How delicate, Dave.
Very open stance. Just popped it up like that.
There it is.
Look at that.
Give himself his own little 10-yard dash.
He's going to spike his wedge or something in the green there. Well, if you don't get excited about that, Jim, nothing will excite you.
Okay, he moves across to the 18th tee. One more hole to go. It's 548 yards long, a par 5 along the seawall. David Graham now, the defending champion here at 1 under par. Started the day 2 under, so he's 1 over on today's round. He was right in it for a while, then dropped back. His third shot safely on the green on the 18th hole. He plays along with George Burns. He's had a bad day today. Burns 7 over for the day. Now back down to where Watson makes that long final walk. He's made it in the Crosby tournament and won. He's made it in the British Open and won 3 times, in the Masters and won twice, but never in this one.
It's like a 3-wood here, Jim.
Beauty.
That ball's right at the big tree.
Okay, but it's...
Ooh, it's long. It's by it, Bob.
Well on pass. Well on pass, Bob. So Watson on the fairway. Should have two more shots to get on the green and then two putts to get down, and he'll have won. Bill Rogers now trailing by three shots in a tie with Bobby Clampett and Dan Pohl for third place.
Going back to Watson's shot, Jim, as good a shot as it was going to go 15 feet by if it hadn't hit the hole. It was just absolutely perfect. You just, well, you'd picked it up and thrown it with your hand. You couldn't have stopped it.
Bob Rosberg was right down there with it. Soon there will only be two players left on the golf course, Rogers and Watson. Applause for David Graham as we prepare for one more break, and we'll be back for the finish of the Open.
Back to the 18th green, the 72nd hole of this year's Open Championship. The defending champion, David Graham, putting for a birdie. Just to go two under. Hard and left. We've seen quite a number take that line. It's almost the same putt that Nicklaus had. Nicklaus was a bit nearer, hit it through the break. And really, this has been an extraordinary championship. Great event. I keep saying that we think we've seen it all, but we never have. Just look at that setting. View from the 18th tee across the edge of the rocks to this green, and here's George Burns. George Burns started the day at two under, now sadly five over. Behind has to play this hole in par.
He has to stand out there and think about it now, doesn't he?
He does. He's not waiting too long. He's just taking an iron.
And a very short iron, Peter, probably a five or six iron. Playing very short.
Safe enough, though. But now we see how far he is from the green. Quite a long way. And when you think of the closeness of that pin to the front, there's still a lot of work here to do for Tom Watson if he's going to beat this man to be the 1982 US Open champion.
We'll be behind the power.
The stage is set now to receive a new champion, but it isn't quite over. Bill Rogers must hit first, then Tom Watson. He must get safely on the green and down in two putts to win the US Open. Rogers trailing by three now, two under par. Tied with Bobby Clampett and Dan Pohl, who have finished. Throwing back, good shot. David Graham, the defending champion, has finished his round now. He had 73 today, one over par at your other rounds of 73, 72, and 69. The disappointed face of Jack Nicklaus, but still watching.
Not disappointed yet. There's still some golf left, yeah.
One that Watson must put on the green now.
Good looking shot in the air. Let's see. Good start.
There you have it.
All right.
Should be able to get down in two.
Isn't this something for this young man?
Only caution we would make is that we've seen several people from up on the high side there go past, including Jack Nicklaus, who had to make a tough one coming back. But let's listen to them now. When he nears the green, I'm sure they'll let Tom Watson of Stanford University let him know that they like him here. Welcome to the 18th, Tom. Listen to that. quiet for the work yet to be done. Rogers will putt first and will probably putt out, and then let Watson finish it up. Almost 8 o'clock back east in the United States, well after midnight in Great Britain and Ireland. They're watching also in Australia. Japan is taking the feed. As you look at some of the other scores, here, many thousands up in the tower with us, former President Gerald Ford. All eyes on one man in a minute. I'm sure we'll be back to the shores of Carmel Bay again, Dave. What a great championship they've had for the second time here at Pebble Beach.
It'd be great to have it here all the time, really. A golf course is marvelous, but you just can't have it in one place every year. It's a big putt for Billy here. He can move into third all by himself.
Oh, yeah.
Move out of a tie with Bobby Clampett and Dan Pole.
Next month, we'll be watching him defend his British Open Championship live on Saturday and Sunday rounds on ABC.
Look at this.
Uh-huh. Hit the back of the hole. That's the kind of a day it was to be for Bill Rogers. Started out tied for the lead. And with that tap in, we'll end up in a tie for third place with Bobby Clampett and Dan Pole. Had he made it, of course, he would have been a solo third. For Bill Rogers, a round of 74 today, after earlier rounds of 70, 73, and 69. And these are sportsmen coming in one after another. Nicholas, Rogers, and now Watson. He said at the beginning, Dave, that should he win this first national championship, so many people expect that might really open the floodgates for him. Maybe many more to come.
Well, he's got to be proud. He's had several disappointments in the Open. He just kept working and trying, and probably no one tries any harder than this young man right here.
What a way to win. What a way to finish. After bogeying the 16th hole, Tom Watson has birdied 17 from off the green, birdied 18. He wins it by two from the greatest golfer of them all, Jack Nicklaus. His first U.S. Open. Happy Father's Day, Tom Watson. Very good.
That's just terrific.
Oh, marvelous. And congratulated now by the man he just beat out, by Jack Nicklaus, four-time winner. There's his wife, Linda, who is expecting another baby come late next fall. They're already the parents of young Margaret Elizabeth, Meg as they call her. David Graham, the defending champion, congratulating him. As I said, when you talk about sportsmen, you must say the game of golf.
Sandy Tatum there?
Yes.
Past Sandy. President of the USGA and a very good friend of Tom's.
Yes, Sandy Tatum and Tom Watson went to Scotland last year. I think they played 8 days in a row or 14 or something like that. Well, let's take a look at how he did it on 18. Watson with a one-stroke lead, you would think he would play it safe coming down this slope with a break on the putt.
Well, he did. It just happened to go in, Jim. It wasn't going to go very far back.
Safest place you can be is right there. Great to see somebody that happy.
He deserves it. He really, really does.
And in, I think that one went into the sea.
Another Stanford quarterback, it looked like.
Look at that. Usually an unassuming sort of fellow, but he couldn't help it. Both fists in the air in victory.
If you're not happy then, Jim, there's no hope for you.
Let's have another look now at the shot on 17. Remember, he had just bogeyed 16 to drop into a tie with Jack Nicklaus. We're so glad we came to see this. Well, you said at the beginning, Dave, that you don't play defensively to win the Open. And that is the philosophy that Tom Watson used. On the offensive, not taking chances, but playing offensive, aggressive golf.
Just play the shot that needs to be played to get you there. Look at this. Run out and I'll hit you with a long one.
Okay. Oh, it's hard to realize it's over. It really is. It's just been such an exciting and warmly thrilling weekend. Nicklaus again and David Graham. Talk about the cream rising to the top during the course of 4 days of play. Isn't that something? Watson, greatest golfer of the last 5 years. Nicklaus, the greatest of all time, probably. Bobby Clampett at age 22. There's the 32-year-old, 42-year-old, and 22-year-old. And David Graham, Lanny Watkins played well. Jay Haas, who had that 68 today. Gary Koch had a 67. The low amateur, once again, Nathaniel Crosby. I must say, Dave, when I saw them putting his name on the board at 18, that he was coming up next, Crosby. But what that would have meant to his dad, Bing Crosby, to see the name Crosby on the scoreboard on the 18th hole of the U.S. Open at Pebble Beach, and his son, low amateur, and that, of course, the current U.S. amateur champion. As the other scores continue to go by, Johnny Miller finished at 9 over. Lon Hinkle and Ray Floyd, who's been the hot man on tour, couldn't do it this week. Bob Shearer from Australia. Vance Heffner, son of a great golfer many years back. Clayton Heffner, Big Clayton. Saddened this week, yesterday, to learn of the death of Dutch Harrison at age 72. There is Tom Watson with one responsibility left. Check that scorecard, because if it's wrong and if he signs it, he's the man who's wrong. Cost him dearly. Now, we're supposed to be going off at 8 o'clock Eastern time, but we're going to stay on in order to have a few words with Tom Watson. It's the least he deserves and we feel that we deserve after one of the great United States Open golf championships.
What he's doing, Jim, he's going over the mind in his round. He had someone else hold the card, and he was calling the scores back, because you can't imagine how your mind is at this moment, trying to put everything together. As you point out, he's got to have the correct score down.
By the way, the program that's coming on following us will not be Joined in Progress. It will come on at the beginning, Caravan, and you'll be seeing the entire film, so don't worry about that. Just stay with us for a word with Tom Watson. Just be a couple of minutes. 5 years ago at Turnberry in Scotland, this man and Jack Nicklaus, head-to-head for the last 36 holes, had what amounted to match play. Nicklaus shot 65, 66. Watson shot 65, 65, and won by a single shot. It was very much like that in the closing holes today. As we await Tom, we should certainly mention in this case that the executive producer of ABC Sports is Rune Arledge, and that the coverage of this Open was produced by Chuck Howard, directed by Terry Jastrow, Jim Jeanette, and Bob Goodrich. What a job they all did. Those pictures were amazing. Technical directors Werner Gunther, Ernie Buttleman, Johnny Allen, and Gary Larkins. Now down to Jack Whitaker.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here's our new national champion, Tommy. How are you?
I am just feeling on top of the world, Jack. I can't explain to you what it means to win the U.S. Open here at Pebble Beach.
I know it's been in the back of your mind. You told us Friday you had to be more positive, less tentative, and you went out yesterday and today and did just that. How about the 17th today?
Well, 17, I don't know what happened. I felt fairly calm over the chip. I had a good lie, although it was on the downslope, and I practiced that shot hours and hours and hours, and it just happened to go in the hole. I told my caddy, I said, I'm not going to try to get it close. I'm going to try to make it, and that's what I did.
You drove so well today, except at 16. And
that's right. I hit a good tee shot at 16. I just didn't aim it properly. I got it set up a little bit to the right, which has been my problem most of the week in the first couple of rounds, but I corrected it in the last couple of rounds. I drove the ball very well today.
You played very well today. Another thrilling duel between Nicklaus and Watson. I hope it goes on for another 10 years.
Thank you, Jack.
Terrific, Tommy. Thank you very much, and congratulations.
Happy Father's Day, Dad.
All right, Jim.
Okay. I think that says it all in a final look at Jack Nicklaus, who fought so nobly. Again, the 1982 U.S. Open champion is Tom Watson. Travel arrangements made through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United flies more people to Hawaii than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.